And we're here today coming from Palo Alto at Pali in the football stadium here for Pali Vikings versus the Sequoia Cherokees.
This should be a really good battle. Two good teams all around. I mean, you already know that their defense is going to bring their A game, and both teams got a couple offensive players that can just break tackles and go all the way.
Yeah, right now we are watching not the varsity team, but the varsity team will be on in a bit, and that is what we are waiting for. This is the other team playing right now before.
This is JV with Sequoia Cherokees beating the Pali Vikings 13-12.
Yeah, so we're going to bring you into this game right now. It is with a minute 35 and counting right now. Vikings 12, down by 1, 13, as it looks like he's going deep. The QB throws it deep, and oh, he can't make the catch. It was so close on the sideline around the 30-yard line, as you can see on the TV.
Beautiful throw there. Just too much, not that great of a decision there. He was in traffic, couldn't hold on.
Yeah, it was very hard to make that play. That was a great defensive coverage by the defensive back right there.
1:25 left.
It looks like we're waiting on the offenses making a plan here. They got to do something good. They need to get a point to tie right here. I'm assuming they go for a field goal if they get in this range, if they get down to the time. If they can get in range for a field goal, they could win the game at the very end. I say they run it. But they're going to throw here as he throws down the – oh, an amazing catch. Wow. What a catch there by number 10.
Also, great play selection. If I'm Pally, I'd just be throwing sideline passes all day, passes, because if you throw it deep, I mean, it's good to get in one play, but it's great if you could try to run down the clock and get that winning drive, and you don't want to have to – be forced to throw it in traffic, and then that's where interceptions come.
And you can't hear it, but everyone was gasping at the look of that catch. That was incredible. The team is clearly pumped up about that. Very, very happy. This is good enthusiasm for Pali right now.
So, time out here. So what do you think that Pali should do here?
I believe with 1:18 left, I think sideline – I wouldn't say – I think they gotta get in field goal kicking range. I'm not sure how good their kicker can kick the ball. But, yeah, we can just – I think that, they should really just get it down in field goal kicking range. And if they still have time, keep running the ball when they're in, keep running the clock, but also being able to get to the range they need to get.
On Sequoia here, I'm not playing prevent. I'm going for the blitz.
Yeah, and it looks like they are going to blitz. They have a halfback pitch down to the running back, number 45. He runs it all the way. Oh, that looks like a – oh, it looks like the running back for Sequoia here is injured. Wow.
Got an injury.
It looks like, I don't know, we might have an injury. He got taken out very hard on the neck, it looked like, almost to me. I think that might be a penalty, but there is a flag on the play. Pali in green, and by the way, Pali is in green, and Sequoia is in white here. So they are calling a knock in the back here. 10-yard for Sequoia, and they need to play for Sequoia right here. I don't know. What do you think, Justin?
That's a big setback because they were at the 20, close to the field goal range. Now I say you got to look for one of your wide receivers on the corner route, probably try to get around the 25.
So here's another pitch outside. He's still running it. Oh, he breaks free. He's going. He's at the 20. He's getting past number 5. He powers through. Fumble. It's picked up by number 7. And he has the ball recovered by Sequoia. Wow. That was just a great moment for Pali that just went straight downhill.
Yeah, it looked like Palo Alto was going to finally be in that field goal range there. And then Sequoia, what a big play by Sequoia.
That was a great defensive play there. I'm mind blown. All the fans here at the stadium for Pally are very shocked of what's happening, what just happened. I mean, it just looks like he ran into, just straight into that guy, tried to power for a couple yards and just got it stripped from him.
And who knows, if there wasn't that block in the black, if that would have been the same play call there.
You're right. So yeah, it looks like it is Sequoia ball here.
Looks like they'll probably just chew the clock out here.
Yeah, I'm going to assume that they're going to run the ball a lot, chew this clock out, and this might be the end of the game for the junior varsity.
So let's see here. Fourth quarter, 44 seconds.
Sequoia just needs to run it. It looks like they're going to kneel the ball for the end here. Yeah, they just need to kneel the ball. Clock's going to run out. This game... I believe this game is over unless something. Pally really needs a great, amazing play right here.
You never know. You've seen it before, just miscue snaps. But let's just see if.
And here's
just
a snap.
Need to hold on to the snap here.
Here's
the
snap
over.
Again. They snap. Oh! Pally comes through. They throw a flag. Wow. Wow. Refs are discussing it here.
Looks like either unnecessary roughness or offsides.
Right. So they're going to call an encroachment, and it looks like just advancing for Sequoia. They got 8 seconds left. So all they need to do is kneel the ball, and they win.
They just need one good snap here, and it's over.
This game is most likely over. I thought Pally had a chance, and that fumble was just I think that's the key play of the game right there.
It is.
That was the key play of the game. And the game is over.
Final score, Sequoia.
Sequoia wins it 13-12 against Pally.
All around great game.
That was a good game. I just think... I'm really shocked as the varsity team's about to come up here. Sequoia... celebrating, obviously, you know, defensive play of the game goes to their defensive player who snatched the ball there. And
yeah, that was a key strip, and you see they're just getting the handshakes here. Sequoia celebrating, and Pally, of course, upset.
Pally very shocked, and they thought they had this game, and it just turned around with one play. That's how football goes sometimes.
It's that one penalty that can do it, and that block in the back was that big penalty.
Yep. That was just key right there, that one set up. So here comes the junior varsity team onto the field here for Pally. They're waving the American flag, coming on. Some of the, we're gonna remind you that there are plenty of seniors in this year's game. Some of them include their quarterback, Justin Hull, who is a very, very talented QB. And as a senior, so this will be his last season he'll be playing.
Especially as a QB, as a senior, too, just think of all that pressure. I mean, your final season, you want to have a great year. I mean, just.
Pally's getting real pumped up here. Here they go. They're getting pumped up. They are pumped, psyched for this game against Sequoia.
As they should be. I mean, a lot of seniors on that team. Final season.
Yeah, it's showing off there. Really enthusiastic here. They are going to try to get back at Sequoia for beating their junior varsity team with that play. And hopefully, we're going to show you some more seniors.
So they see number 9, Takanishi, he's holding the American flag.
He is a great player at his position.
But it looks like he's not in uniform, or?
He is. It looks like he might not be playing this game. We'll see what happens there. As Pally's stretching out here, they're getting warmed up. That's very important when you don't want to get any cramps and injuries. Stretching's always good to do before games.
Worst thing you can do on an NFL field is have a non-contact injury. I mean,
yeah,
it's bad.
What do you think some of the keys to the game are today, Justin?
I mean, you got to establish the run game quick, because you even saw in the junior varsity game, there were some big runs there that were big factors in the game, and a lot of senior running backs there for Pally. And I think also QBs, do not throw it in traffic. Do not force it, especially early in the game. You can't.
Yeah. I would not be throwing that ball into traffic unless you really, really trust some of your wide receivers, like one of the very trustworthy wide receivers, Riley Chauvin Sr. He's a very, very good. I think he's a very, very good wide receiver, in my opinion.
Runs his routes perfectly.
Right. It looks like Sequoia is going to get out there and stretch too. They really need to do the same thing and just beat Pally. They need to play good defense like their varsity team did and really just try to get that special edge there.
Yeah. Because what do you think about the quarterback, Justin Hull?
He came into this school in 2012 on the junior varsity team, and he's here now, number 5. Look out for him this game, because he's going to make some spectacular throws. As long as he does not throw that ball into heavy, heavy traffic, I think he should do just fine with his good wide receivers, good running backs. His offensive line is a very good high school offensive line, and he's got a good defense to play, so we'll see what's going to happen here.
Yeah, I think the seniors for Pally are going to make a big difference in this game. I mean, it's their final year, their first game at home here. Big crowd, all of them expecting big things here.
And, you know, they also have some other players, too. They have, you know, just besides the seniors, they also have some very, very other, very good other players. And you got to look out for them, too. So, you know, seniors, I like how they mix the seniors with the other team, with the other players, so that's great. We got a picture of the cheerleaders here. They're doing a junior cheerleading program. I think that's great.
And Sequoia, this is a big challenge. I mean, just think about having to play your first game on the road at night in a big crowd with Pally, with a lot of seniors trying to prove stuff. And there going to be some people for Sequoia trying to prove themselves, and they can get this win here. They can establish themselves and go forward as a really good team.
Yeah, I believe with you too, but you never know what's going to happen in high school football, as it looks like they're running some drills over on the Pally side and still stretching out Sequoia. We've got 5 minutes. It looks like we have – the game is actually starting now, it looks like. Or it's starting very, very shortly. So this is going to be a very interesting game. Some more keys, I would say. Firstly, they need to make their field goals and punts really count here on both sides of the football.
And how about those PATs in the junior varsity? The PAT / two-point conversions were not committed right by Pally, and Sequoia got that PAT, and that's why Sequoia got one by 1 point. All it takes is one.
You really take those extra points for granted, but really, they're not as easy as they look. They're a kick from not a very far distance. Yeah, but you got to get it up and over that goal, and that's what gave them the win. They won by one. So I mean, if they hadn't made that, it would have been a whole different ball game, and it would have been most likely would have been an overtime, and junior varsity probably still would have been playing right now.
Yeah. And, I mean, it's high school, so you never know what's going to happen on a PAT. This isn't a guarantee on a PAT or a field goal or anything.
Yeah, no guarantees. Let's just hope that Thomas Kervik can make all of his field goals and PATs for Sequoia. Just as long as he does that, I think Sequoia can really up their odds if he can make most of his kicks or all of his kicks.
Talk about how important field position is. I mean, you do not want to be turning the ball over on offense. I mean, just setting it up there for the other team, you don't want to do that. And return, if you can just get that big return, especially in high school football, that's big.
Yeah, and as we saw in the other junior varsity game, that one defensive play can just change everything. One play, even offense or defense. And we saw there that it was a defense that really proved what happened, the outcome of that game. Not as much offense, but that defensive play at the very end. was very, very important and key to that play. If any of those big plays happen, I mean, the team with the most big plays that happen, I'm saying they have a, you know, they might be the winner of this game with the big plays, but the small little things also you got to pay attention to.
And the we saw in the Sequoia Junior Varsity game when someone doesn't make a tackle or something, like on that run, that was like a 20, 30 yard run because there were some broken tackles, and but he the defender picked up for the rest of the missed tackles and just big hit, big strip, big fumble.
Yeah, and that's why you got to have your good running backs that can hold the ball in for this fumble, and they got to be able to break these tackles so they can gain more extra yardage. And I mean, Pelly has some pretty good running backs, and so does Sequoia. And most of Pelly's running backs are senior players, so they're very experienced and they've been taught over a 4-year period how to really hold that ball and not let it get fumbled. But the junior varsity running back did a great job, but that defensive guy just really stripped it right out of his hands, and it was a tough play.
Palo Alto's got some tall wide receivers. They got one guy at 6'2", and they've got some 6'3 tight ends.
They have a 6'3 tight end, which is just, you know, crazy height for high school. His name is Bryant Jefferson, playing tight end and defensive end for Pally. He is 6'3", which is, I think, just crazy. He's over 200 pounds. It's just really good.
As we see the band here.
Yeah, the Pally band really pumping up their players. As you can, you know, this is just going to be an amazing game, and I just can't wait for it to start. It's going to be very interesting to see these two varsity teams, the best of the best in these high school, of these high schools. We're going to see how they can play it out today.
And big things, can Pally get the win in front of their home crowd with a lot of their seniors, or can Sequoia just pull it off on the road?
Yes, that's very, very, very important. But both teams still running some key drills. Pally running some wide receiver drills. And it looks like Sequoia running some tackling drills and offensive and defensive line drills. Those are always key, you know.
Yeah.
Especially the offensive and defensive lines.
Yeah, I mean, it comes down to sacks. Can you pressure the QB? As an offensive and as
exactly.
an offensive lineman, your job is to not let anyone get close, especially your left tackle on the blind side. Do not let your quarterback get hit on the blind side. That's where injuries come from. That's where fumbles come from. Just don't let that happen. Defensive line, of course, big plays. Get the fumble, get the sack. Just a lot of loss of yards, and maybe even a turnover if you can recover the fumble.
Right. And, you know, it's always very important, as we see the Sequoia coaches talking, they have to set this game plan for these high school kids, because these high school players, they're not grown and know exactly what to do yet. These coaches are really their mentors for the rest of their life, and it's really important that they get these plays right and know how to teach these kids. And I think the coaches on both these teams are very good, and I think some of these players can turn out to go pro and be big players in the pros or whatever.
You see a lot of professional players, when they talk about how they got there, they always mention their high school coaches. That's a big part of their...
Yes. Yeah.
I think the defenses, I think both you blitz here. And if I'm the offense, I think you want to establish the run, especially Sequoia. Just kind of get some first downs, get the crowd silent, get some momentum there. And if you're Pally, you want to get that big play early just to show Sequoia that this is
your
home
ground, yeah. Pally really needs, they have a lot more, as I look around the stadium, it seems like Pally has a lot more fans here than Sequoia, which is common because this is their home field, so you would expect more amount of Pally, you know, fans attending today than Sequoia fans. I think the same could happen at Sequoia, where more Sequoia players are fans. And also, one thing we forgot to mention, key play, is these refs really need to get these calls right, and that is very, very important.
Yes, I mean, penalties are a big factor in the game. You saw last game in junior varsity, all it took was that block in the back, sent them back, and then they tried for the big run play there, fought for extra yards, and the ball
fumbled
came out.
Yep. But I think these refs in the, these are the same refs from the junior varsity game. And watching that game, I really thought they got that game right. I really think they called it right. And I think they're going to, keep it up. It's, you know, it's just really important that they get those calls right. And I think they will get those calls right. Majority of the time, these refs are getting them right, which is good. And that's very good that you have good refs.
Another thing we didn't cover is actually the coin flip. I mean, that doesn't seem like anything, but
yeah.
If you think about it, if Sequoia gets wins the toss, I think that you got to receive. You need to run down some of the clock, get some first downs, take the crowd out of the game. And if you're Pally, you could go either way, but I also think that you should receive, because if you can just get that touchdown, that takes Sequoia. Like,
yeah, that first touchdown is always key. So I would, honestly, for Sequoia, I would be receiving it. And if I were them, I would be going from the right side of the field from where you see the camera angle to the, you know, I would have the, I would be receiving from the right side of the field from where the camera angle is, because you can, a very important part is you can see that scoreboard and how much time you have left. Or you, if you choose the other side, you can see that scoreboard, you know, when you're at the very end of the game, which is more tense. So actually, you might want to choose the left side. But that's all up to the captain of the football team.
Yeah, and whoever loses the toss, I mean, that's why it's a win-win, because then you still get to pick your side. And if
right.
If I'm them, I'd pick what you want, like, at the end of the half. I don't
– Right.
First quarter, time management, not as important as
the fourth quarter. You're right. He's perfectly right. Looks like they're running some – over at Sequoia, running some – slant routes and out routes and wide receiver routes that are very important. Looks like goal line plays. Very important. We get a shot of some of these loyal Pally fans that are attending tonight. Sequoia running some pass plays. I also think that it's going to be very important in, you know, landing these passes near the sideline when it comes towards the end of the game. When you're losing, you got to get these passes near the sideline and out of bounds as soon as possible.
Especially in high school, the two-minute warning drill. I mean, you practice it a lot, but even you can never perfect it. And you get tackled, I mean, just the amount it takes. I mean, talk about sacks with 2 minutes to go. To the quarterback, even if there's a chance of intentional grounding, unless you're close to field goal range, I just throw it away. Even if you're close to field goal range, just throw it away. Stop the clock.
And that goes back to that offensive line. Just very important to keep that offensive line going. Yeah, it's just very, very, very important, I would say. Do you have anything else to talk?
The wind. I mean, sometimes you talk about the wind. I mean, field goals,
yeah,
it could really affect. I mean, the football. I mean, especially if you're kicking an easy field goal, it looks like you have, and then the wind's shifting kind of to the left and it blows it away, but not much wind here. Not really a breeze. Not that cold out either. It's kind of a nice warm night. It's a great night for football here on Friday night. Lights.
Yes, it is. And it looks like Pally getting another huddle down at the right side of the field. They're taking a knee. I think they're going to get some pump up motivation from their captain right in the center there. It looks like their motivator today is Cabello Santana, who, that's very, you know, he's one of their seniors. He's a key player. He's their running back and linebacker. So he is just going to pump up this team. They look very pumped up and ready to go right now. I see some players in there are not dressed, so I believe that some players are not playing tonight. Actually, never mind. Those are just coaches. But
there's a couple, though.
Yeah, I do see some players that are in high school and are not, you know, dressed with their full jerseys on. Maybe they're gonna go change for the halftime, or maybe they're not playing. But that's, you know, important if you have injured players and whatnot.
We saw Talk Nishi. We did not see him dressed before. That's gonna be a big factor to see if he plays in this game. And we saw also, not in uniform, is Charlie Munoz, running back and linebacker. So if the other run backers, including the one of their seniors here, they really got to pick it up. I mean,
right. It looks like we are about to start the game here. Teams are on their sidelines getting hydrated, and that is very important.
Worst thing you can do is not be hydrated.
Oh, yeah.
Especially those big hits running around. You just take the hit, and then there comes the headaches, and then you realize you didn't drink any water, and that's where panics come. Then you got to bring in someone else for those couple plays, and then those can be big plays in the game.
Right, yes. And it looks like we're going to have the national anthem playing here, so please take off your caps and please join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Nicely done there by the Pally Band.
That was great. As both teams really now need to get mentally prepared, this is time for mental preparation right now. They need to focus their minds only on football and how strategically to beat their opponent. It's very important that they do that.
Yes, I agree with you, because we talked about physical errors being a big thing, but talk about mental errors. I mean, you forget the play, you just get the wrong thing on defense. You're supposed to be blitzing, but you drop back, or you're supposed to hand off. Running back doesn't know what's going on. Those miscues can kill you.
And it looks like we have the refs and the captains captains today for each team coming to the middle. It looks like we're about to have the coin toss go on. So let's see what's going to happen in this coin toss.
Notable captain out there, Justin Hull, quarterback for Sequoia and for Pally.
Yes, he's one of their captains. He's a great quarterback too and a great team leader. So it looks like the coin toss is happening right now. We'll try to tell you what's the outcome is going to be right here.
As we see Sequoia there, I mean, they really need to stay focused, because one mental error, especially on the road, I mean, crowd noise, that's where false starts come, is the loud crowd noise, can't hear your quarterback.
And here, as we get a shot of the coin toss, it looks like they already tossed it. He's picking it up. It looks like the coin toss is awarded. The coin toss is, it's hard to tell who. Looks like the coin toss.
Sequoia has won the toss.
Sequoia has won the toss.
That means you're going to want the ball.
And it looks like they have deferred.
Ooh, I'm not sure about that. I mean,
yes,
you're really going to give Palo Alto the ball to start the game? I mean, but
that's a very tough decision. But they obviously have some strategic reason. You know, one reason might the ref doesn't quite have to, I think that Sequoia, they really should go ahead and, Sequoia, they might have a strategy here. Sorry, I was trying to get that out. They might have a strategy here for doing this. They could want to score in the second half rather than the first half and try to get that momentum building.
Just think if they can hold Pally here, how that changes the momentum of the game. I mean, then they get the ball, start the second half. That will work out, because if you're on the road, you don't want to, and if it's a close game, maybe you don't want to start second half there without the ball.
And here is the kicker, Thomas Kervik. Very important that he can get a good kick, kick it very deep. And it's good. That's going to really help. So they're getting pumped up here, and they're about to kick it off. This Sequoia team is one of the most pumped up teams I've seen. But it looks like Pally's getting more of a mental focus right here, and they're ready to receive this ball.
As Takanishi by the sideline is not dressed, so he will not be playing in this one.
Well, he may play, but he's not going to play right now, obviously.
Well, yeah, he's not in his football pants there.
Right.
In khaki shorts, it looks like.
So it looks like the Sequoia kicking team is heading onto the field. The Pally receiving team is ready to receive right now.
Sequoia needs to get a good kick, tackle him, because you cannot let this game start with a big return.
Yeah.
Momentum's one of the big keys when it comes to football. When the momentum's not on your side, it's really hard to win.
Here, the ref is handing the kicker the ball. It's going to be very, very important for Thomas Kervik to kick a good ball here. He's getting back. He's ready to kick. Here it goes.
Let's see how this kick works. You see all the crowds really pumped up here.
Very pumped up for the kickoff of this game. The kickoff, the game has started now. Ball is deep. Oh, it's dropped by the Pally returnman, and it's going to be called by the refs.
As that's a touchback there. Just talk about, that's exactly how Sequoia wants to start the game. The muff or kickoff there by Pally, and now they just start back there.
And I thought when I was watching that might have been even a safety, because if that hits off his hands, when the ref calls that down in the end zone, that is technically a safety. But I think he, you know, the Pally receiver returner must have called off for just to get the ball at the 20.
Well, he has to also be down there for a safety, but no one tackled in there.
Justin Hull, he gets it. He's gonna run it. Ooh, swallowed up by the defense there. A great run from Sean Pike. That was a good run. I mean, he got some good yardage there, and that's what you want from out of your running backs. A big guy that can power it through there, get the yards you need him to get.
Yeah,
and that's exactly what
game.
He is.
To start the game with a nice, simple run there. I like the play call. Just not enough holes there to really get anything.
Yeah, the starting QB is Justin Hull, the senior, who is a captain. And here it's another handoff. Oh, and he's still powering through, but he gets tackled down. Tony Cavallaro-Santana right there with not a great run, but it was a good. It looks like that was just right there, second and two. And now it is third down, which is very important. It's third down and eight. They lost 1 yard there, so that's important. They need to, if I'm them, I throw a slant pattern, get that first down right now. What do you think?
I think you got to throw a slant, you got to throw a flood down the middle. Just look
yes.
for some separation.
You got to get away from that defense. You don't want to give up an interception right here. That would be tragic. And assuming, yep, they're going to throw it here. QB getting rushed. He throws. It's caught. Oh! It was in his hands, and it slips out. Sean Pike. I mean, that was Matt Casey on the coverage there. He did great coverage. Intimidated, really. The wide receiver to make him drop it, and that's a very also a big part. Now it's fourth and eight.
Just talk Pally's about how big that was by Sequoia. That's exactly where you want to start the game. As you see, there are two returners back there.
Yeah, and it seems like this is going exactly planned. They kicked it first, and they get it as the punt goes. Ooh, it is kicked pretty far. Returned. It looks like it is hit out by Sequoia at about the 42.
So let's see if the Sequoia can now get a score here.
Their quarterback, Nick DeMarco, is going to be very important to throw some good passes. But I'm assuming that they might surprise Pally by throwing pass first instead of run like Pally did.
Yeah, how about a play action pass deep to just start it off?
I think that could just give them momentum, and that could just give them the win almost there. So, as we see, they're setting up for the play here. The ball was downed at about the 42-yard line. And here's the snap about to happen. Looks like they have a... It looks like they're going in a with the QB. Then they got two backs in the backfield. And
looks like they're doing a wild cut.
Oh, it is. And it's given to the big guy. Oh, he gets taken down at about the 44-yard line, 2-yard gain.
That was Fabe Brown.
That was tackled by Tyler Wilcox. That was a great tackle there. And the refs, it looks like some players setting up. They got three out wide to the left here. Let's see what they do with those three. I'm expecting And it looks like
you with the fellas.
Looks like there's a 5-yard penalty for a false start on Pally. Looks like they moved a little too soon.
Looks like, yeah, awesome. Quarterback there, drop back.
Takes a snap. He's looking at the throw to right, and it looks like it's incomplete. Nice play there by Pally. Very, very good. Third and three. Very important here for Pally to stop him if they want to keep, you know, they want to get this ball back right now and make sure it's.
I think here you go to Renick Sloan here, your wide out. You see number 8.
Yes. Oh, it looks like they faked the pass. He's running. He's moving. He throws. Oh, it's dropped. It is dropped by number 22, the wide receiver. And White Brown. And
that was LaMania Brown there. Not
right. It looks like the ref on the mic here. It looks like they are not punting. So they're going for it here. Fourth and three. This is important. They run it to the big guy. Oh, he's getting stuffed. He's stuffed. And the ref blows a whistle. Let's see what he has to say.
Saying that was...
No gain on the play. Turnover on downs, as you can hear the ref saying. That is a key play from Pally. They just stuffed him. They stuffed him. So
let's see. Fabe Brown was stopped there for no gain, and now Pally gets the takeover.
Right, Pally gonna try to do a different approach here. Their running game wasn't quite working for them. So let's see what they have to do here.
Looks like a run here.
They have an I formation. And he play action pass. He goes deep. Oh, he's open. He catches it. Touchdown, Pally. What a play. Wow.
And that was Eli Gibbons there,
Eli
senior.
Gibbons, we got a replay here. He just goes deep. Justin Hope with a bullet pass. And there's the wow. What an amazing play.
And the momentum is now on Pally's side. And now let's see.
Very, very important. That was great. Very pumped up here is Pally. Very, very pumped up.
So kick the PAT here. Lefty kicker.
PAT. Should be an amateur attempt here. But these kicks, you never know what happens. It's good. So 7-point lead for Pally here as they're going to kick off to Sequoia.
See, Sequoia can just get a big return here and just
that was a very long pass. I was like, that was 48 yards. I mean, in one play, too. 48 yards gained right there in just one play. That was incredible. As we get a close-up on the Pally bench right here. Very enthusiastic, very happy. Very happy team right now, as they should be.
I love the play selection. I mean, my formation looks like they're running. They just fooled Sequoia's defense, and you could see the DBs there. They thought that it was a run, got fooled, and that's what caused the separation there.
And not to give some bad news for Pally fans, but this game is definitely not over. It's still first quarter with 9 minutes left in the first. So we have a lot of time left, but this is definitely a very, you know, big play for Pally as they kick off here. Kicker number 11 stretching out, getting ready to kick. He's pumped up for the kick, and he kicks off. A nice deep kick, and it's caught by the returner. Returner taking it back. He's got past some of the line. That's a good return to about the 27-yard line. Great return by number 27. Number 27 with a great, great return there. So as you can hear the refs, they got a personal foul on number 15. The ref is taking strides to put the ball in the right place. I think he made the right call. There looked like there was a foul there.
Yeah, I saw it too. So it looks like the ball will be placed around the 42-yard line.
42, yep. There was a call for illegal use of the hands there, so that's a, you know, you need to keep your hands, you know, using them properly and not trying to shove and whatnot. As they give it to the running back, he powers through. Pally's trying to strip it from him. They're getting a big, almost maul here, just
once
pushing
again,
each other.
They give it to the running back Brown there.
Yeah, he's been given to the whole time. You know, when he comes
yeah,
out
Peter's
there,
got your
he
spot.
Looks.
Peter's got your spot.
It looks like he's playing the fullback position. He's a very big guy, but he's just running the ball every time. He must be the halfback.
I say you gotta go with the play action here, throw it deep down.
Here he is back in the backfield now. And it is a play action pass. They go deep. Oh, right through the fingers of the wide receiver. Mm-mm.
Yeah, just
wow.
Big drop there by number 22, LaMania Brown.
Very, very tough play. They had a lot of defense on him. That looked almost like the catch that the Pally receiver made the just a couple plays ago for the touchdown.
Okay.
And now it's 3rd and 8, so this is very important.
Let's see. I think they should throw a slant out to Renick Sloan here.
Yeah, they hopefully go with the slant pattern as they block in for the QB. They throw a screen pattern, and he's still running. He's going. Oh, he's broken the defense. He's still going. Oh, and he's taken down. That was a great run there. Taken down at about the 36-yard line. It looks like he's hopping off the field, so he might have a little injury in the ankle, legs.
Well, you see, Sequoia's giving him a lot of praise there.
So it looks like there another illegal use of hands call on Sequoia this time. 1st and 10. Very good.
No, it looks like they're just going to take away that play.
Yeah, that is – I did not notice that, but they were at the 30-yard line, and now it looks like they're all the way back where they started. Oh, they're going to – so it's 3rd and 2. It's 3rd and 2, and that's an interesting call. I don't understand the yard is taken back, but obviously the refs made the right call there. They know what they're doing out there. Ooh. Yeah, you saw that.
Looks like an offsides there.
There's definitely an offsides play on the defensive player, as you could easily see on this camera. Encroachment.
5-yard penalty. Yardage results in first down.
Right.
And that is the call.
Easy call there by the ref. Easy play. The guy just advanced to her. That's that snap count. Very important, Justin.
Yeah.
As it looks like the QB. Oh, he's about to get sacked. He's getting blindsided. Take it from behind. Take it out by number 50. Wow.
That is
Tongo Lachu. He did great play right there by number 50, Tongo Lachu.
And that, he's a senior there. I mean, that's the
big
play.
Another senior play. The seniors have been getting so many plays, and that's what's important. That's what's been really very important. Second and 11 here. They lost a yard. That's just a great sack there. Just nothing given up as the play goes. They're going to hand it off to number 26. He's running. He's powering through. Taken down. Swamped by the whole Pally defense.
Alberto Vasquez, pretty decent run there.
Short gain, but it was worth it.
Now let's see if
Troy Henderson, the third, made that stop there. It was a pretty good tackle, along with his teammates helping him out. But that's all about teamwork.
I think you go deep.
Here he goes running. Oh, he's stuffed. Woo. Wow, Justin, what do you think of that? He just got taken down right there.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that play call, though. I mean, third and eight, really the run, but I guess.
Yeah.
Sequoia has some, like,
tricks up their sleeves. Tricks up their sleeves.
Plays there. I mean, I think that something is cooking here for Sequoia. There's something going on that we do not know.
Pally defense is just stuffing them, and they're trying to stick to that run, but so – like this, the run this drive has not been good, and it looks like they are going to punt it away here. So let's see.
There's some big plays there by Tongo Latu.
Yeah, he made those two stops. Oh, it's a fake. Is this a fake punt here? Oh, no, it is a real punt. Sorry. Out about the 10-yard line.
Nice punt there.
Very good punt. Yard line is where it's called out of bounds. And still the score 7-0.
So last drive here we had Justin Holt throwing a big touchdown there to Eli Givens. I think that you got to establish the run a little. And I think then once you get the run established, get a first down, then you go that play action deep pass again.
Right. You got to establish the run and then play action it out. That's the best strategy they have here.
It'll totally fool
them. As we have 6 minutes and 42 seconds left in this first quarter. A lot of game left. Looks like they're giving a pitch out. He's running through the defense. Oh, he got hit shoulder on shoulder with another player, Sequoia.
Looks like there's a little.
Paul Jackson, the third, again. He also made a great defensive play on a tackle with his teammates, and he's making a great running play. That's what's awesome about Pally. They have the talent players that a guy will go on and play as running back, and then he'll come out on the defensive end and tackle someone after making a big run or something. That's what's good about Pally.
Now entering the game for the offense, Sean Pike. Let's see if he'll make a big play here.
He's playing running back. I'm assuming they're going to use him to block here as they run either a play action or just a simple pass play. And it looks like they are. Oh, they ran a fake reverse, it looks like, and the running back is taken down around the 30-yard line.
And that's a big foul there. It's going to be second down.
Again
here, but way back, so erase that nice run, and let's see. Now I think you go play action.
There are a lot of penalties being called. High school, in high school some – they, they haven't got them at almost the full maturity. They're very mature players, but they haven't got the full maturity of like pros, where there's a lot of, and that's what's exciting about these high school games. There's a lot of fouls, and sometimes and it just helps the game. I mean, it just makes the game a little more interesting.
Yeah, I mean, that's why don't foul. Just never foul.
So it's second and 12, and the QB's getting rushed. He has to throw it away. Wow, that could have been a safety, Justin.
Yeah.
I mean,
good thing there was a receiver in the area. That could have been intentional grounding and a safety.
True.
Great job by Justin Hull, knowing there was a receiver around the area and just getting away, throwing it away, because that's how Sequoia could get their momentum back, is the safety there.
Yeah, that's a very veteran move by him as a senior. That's, just very, very important that he can know exactly what to do in that situation he also has been given 4 years of good training by these Pally coaches, and that really helps you too.
Because as we were saying before, high school coaches, that's like the big, and that's just a
very
big step
important
in your career.
Yeah. As takes a snap here, Justin going back, getting rushed. Oh, it looks like he's giving the ball off to number five, and he runs it. He goes out of bounds at about the 15. That's not going to get – they're going to have to punt this away.
Great job by Justin Hull, just make sure not a safety there, just running the ball out of bounds, avoiding big hit there too. We're not going to get the first down. Don't just take the big hit like that.
Right, and you don't want – and you want to be able to get in a range where your punter can have enough room to punt too, which is very important.
Yeah, you don't want to punt out of the end zone. That's right. Always bad. As he's close to the end zone there, but not quite.
Not quite in the end zone, which is good for Pally. As he punts it off. It's a good punt. Looks like about 40-yard punt. Oh, he gets wrapped up. Oh, he really got, like, he really sidestepped that player right there. And that was a great, you know, move.
That was number 22 there, LaMania Brown. Short return, but that broken tackle, always good to get a couple extra yards. So they're in Pally territory here. Let's see. I think you run the first two times, get around like third and five, then play action, go deep to maybe like to like Renick Sloan or one of your other big wideouts.
Right, exactly, Justin. Exactly. And if we haven't announced, your commentators today are me, Luca Girlani, and Justin.
Yep. So as your big key, Renick Sloan does not have a catch here. I think that he needs to get some catches here. Sequoia is going to want to win this game.
Here's a snap. He runs it, it looks like, and just take it down. Oh, helmet's coming off. Let's see what the ref has to say here.
You got to be tough if you want to play in this game. And these players are showing it. So, second down, let's.
Second and eight here. I guess there's no penalty. That's a helmet's fly. I thought something might have happened around the head area, which could have been a penalty, but I didn't really see it, so, you know. Oh, it's a good. Ooh. That was a very close play on the throw there. He just put a little too far out of reach. And those couple inches can really, you know, make a difference.
And I just want to mention a great job so far by Ty Wilcox, limiting Renick Sloan to zero catches. That's big. Their right. Number one wideout there without a catch. I mean, that frustrates a quarterback.
Oh, yeah. They got to have their good wideout. And he's just limited this team down.
And Renick Sloan is not in the game now. So.
Which is very key for the for both teams. And it looks like... He is. Ooh. Way to go.
That's number 90, Brian Jefferson there.
Great defensive play.
So, big punt here. So let's see. We can get a big return there for Pally. Let's just get a big return. Keep the momentum on their side. They're up by seven. I think they need to really.
And here's the snap. Here's the punt. Two players from Sequoia ran into each other on the punt, as you can see, and the punt is looks like called fair catch. Now, while we have a little chance right now, we can take a break. Don't you love pizza, Justin?
I do. And if you want good pizza, go to Pachi's. Pachi's began in the summer of 2004 in Palo Alto with an expert pizza maker with a passion for fresh, deep pizza and genuine hospitality. Today, Pachi's delicious pizza and signature customer experience is a neighborhood favorite. When you walk through the door of Pachi's, you're in for a treat. When you sit down at our table, you're family. Enjoy a Pachi's pizza today.
And I know I'm going to enjoy my Pachi's pizza at halftime when I get my free slice. As they run the ball here, Pally right down the middle. Ooh, I don't know if you could see on your right now, but it looks like that was a tackle around the neck area. It might have been a little lower, yeah. But to me it looks like, yeah, by Caviero Santana. That was a great play. So I really think Pally in the huddle right here got to have that mental part. So we also have it's very important that they stay mental. And here's a snap. So Let's see what happens here. As they run the ball down the middle. Oh, he breaks through. He's going. Oh. Justin, that was a very gnarly play, I would honestly say.
Yeah, just a great job there by Sean Pike. I mean, that's exactly what you want to do there, get a first down.
Right.
I think you go play action deep here to Eli Givens. He has one touchdown. Why not give him two?
And that's why I put him in. He could be a very deceiving player. He's like, you know, I'm going this way. Oh, nope, I'm going this way. You know, he just, like, really confuses this defense. And that's why he's, you know, one of their better running backs on Pally.
I think here you have him run in and out here, and he's really good at running routes, and I think that he can run the in and out play properly.
And on the far left, it looks like number 15, the wideout, is left open as we – oh, they run the ball. To the left side, you can see, but there was a wideout, and it looks like he was very slowly covered. T. Cavalero Santana was not very covered there by the defense. They might have forgotten about it, but they ran a run play, which, you know, they could have just changed that play, but it looks like no one really noticed him out there.
We haven't seen a play action pass in a while, and I think that's where you go right now.
Right, yeah. They need to play. Honestly, I think they need to, yeah, they need to pass the ball. I mean, they've been running the ball and it's working, but it's not, you know, the second and 11, they need to pass it here. And they do pass it, but he's getting rushed. He almost sacked. He gets the throw away. Wow.
When that ball's in the air, you never know what's going to happen. That could have been a big pick there by Sequoia.
Yeah, but, you know, they had, I mean, that play, Justin Hole, great move. He just knew how to come outside, and he was being chased by two guys and was able to throw it away when he felt them on his chest.
Actually, the only thing I would have done there is maybe just thrown it away. I mean, you never know what's going to happen. If you throw it like that, it could just get tipped up, intercepted, and Sequoia's got the momentum just like that.
Yeah, that might, you know, I think that was the best choice, though, because you can't really see the wide receivers across the field, and that's really risky. So,
but you could just throw it out by there.
Yeah, you are right.
He was out of the pocket.
Here we go. We got a good camera angle here. And Justin Holt going back, finds his receiver to the – ooh, he drops it. Just a tough pass, a little high from Justin Holt, thrown to Quentin Valenti.
Actually, Paul Jackson there.
Oh, Paul Jackson. And he just – it was a little too high, and that was a little unexpected. A very common error that happens on those little screen plays. So – you know, that always just can happen.
Big punt here by coming from Maximilian Dorward.
So Max Dorward, yep. And he kicks it. It's a high, nice kick. Caught. No. Pally downs it at about the 36-yard line.
That was interesting almost, because if one of those Sequoia players touches it and doesn't come up with it, Pally gets it, that's a fumble. And
yeah.
And
that's why I think the Pally player grabbed it with urgency rather than just waiting for it to roll out so he could tap it down, because he thought maybe one of them touched it. So
yeah, you never know. And, I mean, that's the right play, just taking the chance that maybe there was a touch there. And even if it didn't pay off, I agree with him there.
Right, and I might want to remind you that there's 2 minutes and 30 seconds left in the first quarter as Sequoia takes it, throws it long, way over the head of the Sequoia wide receiver. Might have just slipped there off the QB's hands, it looks like.
And you see Renick Sloan, they're really trying to get him in the game, but he's never open because a great job by Tyler Wilcox.
Right.
So let's see. What's going to happen here? I think you go draw, because the running game
play,
for Sequoia,
right,
has been the big part of this game.
Yeah, and it looks like they play action here. Go deep. The QB connects. Oh, and he's still going. He's at the 10. It's a touchdown.
Touchdown for Laminia Brown.
Incredible play. Wow. Sequoia very pumped up. It looks like just on that play, we're going to see a replay here. And look at that play. He just catches it and shakes off the defensive end.
What a great decision by the quarterback there. Seeing he was open, saw the opening, and no one knew that was going to be such a big play, and it just broke in tackles, and that's what happens.
Yeah, that was a great play. The sideline obviously pumped up. and they go for the extra point.
I wonder where the safeties are. That's their job.
I know the safeties looked like they were departed to the wide receivers. There were three wideouts to the left, which is where the safeties had to go, which is important. Oh, it looks like we gotta listen on the ref here.
So let's see what the foul is.
Snap infraction. Kicking team number 50. 5-yard penalty. Replay the try. Untimed down.
Okay, so there's a penalty on the kicking team, as you heard, and they're taking the kick back 5 yards.
That's big for high school football because you never know from this extra distance if he's going to make it.
Yeah, because in the pros and whatnot, you know, this is a pretty routine kick, but this is just high school. You got to remember that. And it's in. Very nice kick.
No, it's not.
Oh, it's not.
And that's what we talk about, penalties and these extra points, two big parts of the game, and Sequoia just not playing discipline there.
Right. That was just, like, Sequoia going, you know, getting that penalty was very key because now he just misses it. I mean,
yeah, couldn't say it better myself.
It is 7-6 Vikings because of that missed extra point there.
See, Sequoia, I mean, there's still stuff to celebrate there. They got a touchdown, got back in the game. So just because of the extra point, you can't forget about the touchdown.
And something that was very important was making those kicks count as we went over in this before the game started. And so far, Sequoia's missed their only kick of the night, which they're 0-1, and that's not going to help them.
And we saw their junior varsity team. The reason why they won was the extra point. Let's see if that the varsity team loses this game because of that. You never know.
Exactly. Is Sequoia getting ready to kick off here? Very important that the Vikings have this one-point lead, honestly, with 2:15 left in the quarter. This could be some momentum going
into the
second.
Returner back there, Paul Jackson the third. He's going to be looking to get a big return here.
And here it is. It's picked up by, oh no, it is out, so that's going to be down at the 40. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to call it around the 20 there.
Yeah, my bad. The NFL rule is that the ball goes to the 40. But
it looks like it's going to be placed at the 35.
Because I think the rule in high school is that you go up, you go plus five.
So and, let's see what happens here.
So they add 5 yards there, and it's going to be at the 35. We have a timeout by Sequoia.
See, I guess there's some confusion on defense.
Yep.
We're talking about the mental errors. You're wasting a time out there by not knowing where to be.
But, I mean, if this was, you know, almost the end of the third quarter, this would be a big mistake. But it's the first quarter, so it's okay to be using these timeouts, which is really what all football teams do. They can use their timeouts, spread them out between in the first half. You know, it doesn't really matter saving the time. But when you're in the second half, you need to save your timeouts for the end so you can stop the clock if you're losing, or to just, I mean, when you need a break and like your team is not, you know, doing what they're supposed to be doing, you can just calm it down with them and just talk to your team.
Yeah. So 7-6 here, we got 2:15 left to play. So
yep,
let's go. If I'm them, if I'm Pally, I mean, I don't get why they just got rid of their the threat there in Eli Givens. I mean, they just haven't thrown it to him in a while, and I think it's time to give him the ball here.
Yeah, but also I think they could mix it up, just do a normal drive here, try to drive down. Don't do anything too special. Just try to get some good power runs, an outside run in there and some throws, and you'll do fine on this drive. As Justin Hull takes a snap, they're going to start by running it down the middle, and he's, it looks like he threw a spin move there, but taken down
as
by Cabrillo Santana. Nice run there. And as we might not have mentioned, fatigue is also a great factor because some of these players are playing two positions, defense and offense, and don't get a lot of breaks.
One guy I want to mention is Hango Latu because he's playing offensive line also, and that's kind of big because I'm protecting your quarterback, and he's out there on linebacker, and he's already been making some huge plays.
Exactly. That's just fatigue is going to set in, and that's why they have all these substitutions on the Pally bench as they hand it off here. He breaks through the tackle. He's still going, sidestepping everyone, and he's taken down head on. Paul Jackson III. That was a nice run there. Very, very great run for the first down.
And as he said, just pound the ball through the middle. And has some outside runs there. Get some first downs. I know that we said that don't do anything special, but I mean, I think Sequoia can sense this, that you're trying to grind the ball. Maybe at some point here, do a double reverse or even just a normal reverse over to like Eli Givens or one of their speedy wideouts.
Right, and they could also always use the very tricky plays that are sometimes not used for the end of the game and just surprise their opponent. It's a nice run here. It faked our cameraman out. They thought the QB looked like he still had the ball. Nice drop play.
Yeah, Alvaro Santana there once again. He's been having a big impact on this game.
And what I mean by like use some of those plays that are special for the end, use them now because you could use plays like the flea flicker, Statue of Liberty, and those are just use those plays. And there are 47 seconds and counting left. So
since they've been running with Calvaro Santo, I think actually a flea flicker to one of their speedy wideouts there would be a good idea.
Right. And it looks like it's a play-action play. Nice throw. And they're going to call that second down, obviously. It looks like he called it.
That was John Samos there with the catch.
Looks like that's a catch. Let's see what the ref has to say, if he has to say anything. So it's a complete pass for 3 yards.
10 seconds left here in the first quarter. Let's see if they'll get a play
here. Still counting. They're either going to snap this real quick or they just don't really care about it.
Let's
find them. Just throw it for the touchdown. Throw it for the touchdown. Oh, it looks like they're just going to knee it, maybe.
No, they're just letting it go.
Let it go. End of the first.
Great game so far.
So 7-6 here.
That's the end of the first quarter.
Pally and Sequoia. 7 Pally, 6 Sequoia.
So I think here, Sequoia, I mean, they've had some passes overshot here, but as we've been talking about, Rennick Sloan, got to get him in the game. Just throw a screen or something. Just get him involved. Get his confidence up.
So I think this is the time where we should really recap what happened in this first quarter.
Yes.
Not a very high scoring first quarter, just 2 touchdowns scored and 1 extra point missed, which is important.
So we had the big play action pass. Justin Tolt throwing it down to Eli Givens, and extra point was made, big there. Then we had Sequoia coming back, touchdown reception there for wideout number 22, LaMania Brown.
Right.
But the extra point missed mostly because of the penalty right before that, 5 yards.
As you can still see there, number 9 on the Pally sideline, still in some shorts with a belt, definitely not playing. I would assume he's definitely not playing this game.
That is Tak Nishi there, running back and linebacker.
Right. He's an important player, too, because he's a senior, and it's terrible to miss your homecoming game when you're a senior out of an injury or not being able to play for some
reason.
Looks
like there's a bandage around his knee, so hopefully it's not anything with the tear of the cartilage or ACL or anything like that.
But it looks like both teams are.
But he's not on crutches or a wheelchair, so hopefully it's just the sprain.
I'm assuming, he just sprained probably his ankle because it looks like he had a bandage on his knee. It looks like we're going to resume the game here.
See, there's they switch sides here.
Here we go, and he goes running through the middle. Nice play, running to the 30-yard line when he's taken down. Caviero Santana, that was a nice run there.
Actually, that looks like that might have been Sean Pike, actually.
It might look like Sean Pike.
Sean Pike is in the game, and I think this having that nice running back duo where you can go to Sean Pike or Calvaro Santana is a big thing.
Right, and as we see Justin Hull taking the snap. Also, Justin Hull, great QB. And yeah, got
two running backs. Oh, look, both sides jumped. I think that's an offsides.
Part of the snap, encroachment, 62 defense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
That was a encroachment on number 62, as you heard from the ref. And yeah, you just can't keep making, these are mistakes that you're going to need to cut down on. You can make this mistake once in a while, but you got to just wait on that snap count. And once you see that ball move, it's very important.
That is number 62, Marcus Sattell. Big foul there, first and five.
Yep, you got to keep it in your head. And he runs it here, trying to power it through with his friends. It looks, ooh. He gets a push back a little bit. Sean Pike with the carry. And
we've seen a lot of formations with both Calvario Santo and Sean Pike, both just.
And I like there. That duo. I like what Pally's trying to do here with that duo. They're really trying to take charge of this game right now and this drive.
And two different running backs. You got Calvario Santana, who's a nice speed back there, and then you got Sean Pike, big.
Second and two. What I'm doing here is I'm running a play action slant, and I'm slanting it across the middle to your wide out on the right, number 81.
Eli
and it looks like they are going to pick, but they're going to go to the out pattern, and it's an easy completion on the oh, he's still running. He broke the tackle and took for the touchdown.
Wow. What a big play by senior Riley Chauvin.
Wow. If you, you know, just look at that, looking at that play as we have
a replay here.
Just look closely. He catches the out and he's going to get tackled, but he let go. The running back let goes and lets go, and he just gets by there. And what a great play to have that focus to take the hit and keep going.
As it's going to be Maximilian Dorward kicking.
As the kick is up, and it's good.
Maximilian Dorward, he's had great kickoffs, and he's really getting his PATs in here.
Right, which is very important. And, you know, if he misses that and then Sequoia scores and makes their kick, it's a tie game. But now if Sequoia scores and makes their kick, they're still up by one. And
if I score here, I'm going to go with the two-point version.
Right.
Not much harm done if you don't get it. And
very true.
Just you never know about the PAT. Just having the chance to tie the game is really
very
big.
Important. And when you have that, you know, you got to try that the one to the on the very outside where you're just going straight and then you just cut to the back corner of the end zone.
And how about key to the drive here is get Renick Sloan involved in this game.
I know.
He's number eight out there, Renick Sloan. I mean, just not a factor, and that's all, as we were saying before, Ty Wilcox has just shut him down. What a great DB to have on your team.
Yeah, I'm thinking that, you know, he's the X factor. If he can get going, this game could be flipped around totally.
Yeah, and how about their big running backs / fullback in Fave Brown.
Nice kick deep. You're going to catch this in return. Here's the run. He's running down. He's at the 30. He's shifting every. Oh! It's a very head-on collision there and just knocks him out of bounds. The Pally player knocks him out of bounds.
What a great return there. That's exactly what you want there from your returner.
It looks like, you know, the Pally kickoff defensive player really looked like he went for a little more than just a tackle to get out of bounds. He was really going for him to try to knock him out of bounds, and that's something you need to look at. This is a rivalry, too. I mean, this homecoming game, you got to try to win this if you're Pally.
See the motion taking
the snap. He's number 24 taking it. He throws it deep. It's hit off the back of the Pally. Imagine if the Pally DB right there just turned around.
Yeah, that's a
That play. That's an interception.
So we've been talking a lot about Renick Sloan not being involved, but a lot about LaManya Brown picking up the slack a little there with some big plays.
Right. Yeah, exactly. Score is 6-14, and we have 10 minutes and 30 seconds left in this second quarter. And it looks like the ball was run and stuffed right around the 36-yard line.
So I think offensive line, I mean, they really have the defensive line for Pally is really swarming. And if you're the offensive line for Sequoia, you really need to pick it up here. Protect your quarterback.
There was
protect
no
your
gain.
Running back.
Sean Pike on the tackle there. No, for no gain.
Sean Pike like playing good defense.
Here's the QB throwing it out to the left to the running back. He's taken on the screen. He's going past. Oh, taken down at the 50. Fought by Brown with a great play there, the running back.
Wow.
15 yards right there.
I mean, the having a big halfback who has speed and can catch screens,
he
that's
could be
crazy.
Great. He could be great, I think.
Yeah, just make sure his high school coach is so important there.
Right, as we've talked about. And he runs it to him again. Ooh, he's just stuffed right there at the at around the 49. Maybe a 1 yard, 2 yard gain there. Not much else.
Yeah. I mean, it's always good to establish the run, but, I mean, we're in the second quarter. Your run game should be established, as we've seen, as Fave Brown actually coming out here. But I think it's time you need to start passing the ball.
Yeah, you're right.
Because we have some receivers open.
Snap to the QB. He's going through. It looks like he's going to run. No, he throws it. And it's caught at the 31. It looks like he almost crossed the line of scrimmage there. But he did not, and he was very close to crossing the line of scrimmage, but he was smart right there knowing where the line of scrimmage is.
That was a great catch there by Elijah Frazier, first of the game.
Right. So here's the snap again. They run it to the left, and he's stuffed, taken down at the 35. Probably a 1 yard gain, maybe
Let's
two.
I just think Tonga Latu and Sean Pike, they can really play on both sides. Sean Pike, good running back, good defensive linebacker there, and Tongu Latu, great linebacker, great offensive lineman.
And here's the snap taken to the QB, running right. He throws it down the middle, and it's, oh! Wow, that was an interesting play, but it's incomplete.
And you see some frustration from Pally,
yeah.
Knowing that they could have had that pick there.
Oh, yeah, it was tipped off the receiver on the white, and it seems like the time now is, we have 8:30 left, 8 minutes, 30 seconds left in the half, in the whole half. And we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back, but in 8 minutes, 30 seconds. So in that play, he just tipped it up, and it kept bouncing off each player, but no one could really get a handle on it. And here's the snap. Takes the ball. Getting rushed by number 90. Oh, almost sacked. Oh, so close to being picked off there, but it was knocked down by the offensive player. The offensive player almost playing defense there. To stop them.
The blind side is not being covered at all for Sequoia there. I mean,
right.
You've got to pick that up.
And that's very important to have your left tackle blocking that blind side. He's got to be good, number 57. It looks like they just had a two-man rush on that blind side right there, and that's what really caused him to not give that up. As it looks like another play to the QB. He's throwing it deep, caught on the outside.
LaMania Brown, once again, what
they're
we were talking about.
They're calling it caught at about the 14-yard line.
I mean, you got to think, wow, 4th and 8, you're going for
completion.
It. But, I mean, we talked about Sequoia making some questionable calls, but it paid off at the end, and we're starting to see how it's paying off.
1st and 10, it looks like.
I think you got
to
go running slow
to
touchdown
here.
Here's
the hike. He fake runs it, and there it is. Donays at the 10, taken out about the 10-yard line by the Pally players. Looks like number 44 got in a little extra shove with the Sequoia player.
Yeah.
But that's just common, being just playing around. You know,
gotta be
that
tough. You got to represent your team in football, and these guys are showing it.
Looks like the quarterback looking at the play from the sideline. He's got his play. He's ready to take the snap. He's snapping. It's a run. It's a draw play. Oh! He takes it to about the 2 yard line. That was a good draw play right through the middle, just sneaky, slithery, making it through. First and goal.
I think he just pounded in here. We do not see Fave Brown, which is kind of unusual, saying he can play kind of like a fullback and he can just grind up the
middle.
Yeah,
he could shove it through. I'm surprised they're not subbing him in here, but maybe they have something else planned.
Maybe there's an injury or something that we don't know, but Alberto Vasquez is the halfback.
I remember he was limping off the field as he gets stuffed, taken back to the 5. The running back you're talking about, he got taken off the field in the first quarter, but he came back. Maybe something to do with that. It looks like a Pally player injured on the field.
Ooh.
Grabbing his leg. Not good.
See, yeah, just these injuries. First game of the year, it just sucks to have. And, you know, they already have some injuries.
Yes, already. They did. So I think that really Sequoia needs – they got to get the touchdown here. That's great for them. Pally stops them. That's, you know, great for Pally. It looks like 56 being taken off the field.
That is Mikey Grandy. So let's hope for a quick recovery there.
Yeah, you know, you get fresh legs on the field now for him, which is sad that he got the injury, but you get fresh legs on the field, and that's always good.
And we have Fave Brown back in the game, halfback.
I'm assuming a run here. Oh! Yeah, you can easily see on the outside a linebacker false start. Let's see what the refs say.
Encroachment. Defense number 3. Half the distance to the goal. Still second down.
Now, Fave Brown could just run it in here. I mean, that's a big foul.
Big foul. Second and 2 because they were on the 4. They're taking it by half. And
Fave Brown's just had a great game so far. Great
running
back. I would
stack that offensive line and just power it, which is what they're going to do. Powering it through for, it looks like, the touchdown. Yep, they get the touchdown.
Now I think that you got to go for 2 here.
Yes.
Maybe even just give it back to Fave Brown. That guy is,
I totally agree with you.
He is a great running back.
I think even spice it up with a throw maybe. Like, stack everyone in, like tight ends and offensive linemen. But then, you know, kind of throw it out, you know. See, it looks like, oh, maybe they're going to go for the extra point.
See if they give it. Yeah, they're just going to go for the extra point.
They could
point
fake
here.
It always, but they don't, and they kick it in.
Nice kick there by
their kicker.
By Thomas Kervik.
Yep. He's a good kicker. He missed that first extra point, but that's because it was taken back because of his offensive line on the encroachment.
In case you missed it, if you really want a good pizza, you got to go to Pachi's. As you know, if you heard before, Pachi's began in the summer of 2004 in Palo Alto with an expert pizza maker with a passion for fresh, deep dish pizza and genuine hospitality. Today, Pachi's delicious pizza and signature customer experience is a neighborhood favorite. When you walk through the door of Pachi's, you're in for a treat. When you sit down at your table, you're family. Enjoy a Pachi's pizza today. Mmm, that sounds delicious.
Yep. It looks like Pally getting ready for the reception, and they're getting ready
back
to kick.
There? We have Paul Jackson, the
as
third
usual,
back there.
He's their main guy when it comes to punt and kick returning, and why not? He's got a lot of speed, and he can muscle through these guys. He's perfect guy for the job.
Quick note: I just want to add on the back of the Pally jerseys, instead of having their name on the back, it actually has the American flag,
which is very, very cool. Maybe signifying something about Labor Day coming up this Monday.
Yeah, big Labor Day. Always fun, nice to have a 3-day weekend. Started off with some nice football.
And here's the kick. And it looks like a bounce, but he's got it. Takes it through. Oh, he's sidestepping everyone. He's gotten past everyone. And he's down at about the 43-yard line. What an amazing play there.
That's a big return that we were talking about that you need to see. As we'll see it here. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the kicker. Anything really.
Look at this replay. He just picks it up off the bounce, sidestepping everyone in that giant pile. Somehow gets taken out of bounds, but that was an amazing return.
Yeah, just amazing play.
Like
there.
I said, that's exactly why you want that guy returning for you.
Yeah. Let's see. I think that maybe we can get him in the game here to some screens. You've seen his speed now.
Oh,
now
yeah.
Let's use it on the offensive side also.
Of course.
Or maybe run a wheel with him, see if he gets some separations.
True. He could be deceptive like that.
Palo Alto. They're first.
Palo Alto, so first timeout here, and I mean, that's big.
Yep, they're going to, I mean, after that big return, they want to make sure everyone is, you know, hyped up, but also calm enough to just focus on their game and, you know, just play the game their way, what they want to do. It looks like we get a little close up in the huddle here.
I mean, you can tell the Palo Alto coach is frustrated. He did not want to call that timeout, but those mentalists.
Yeah, it looks like he saw something when they were lining up in the formation. I'm not sure. That was a great return, though. It's we see this camera, and in the huddle, it's just their main QB, Justin Hull, talking to the team, making sure they're calm but also excited at the same time, which is very key.
So let's see if they'll keep going with the run or they're going to mix it up here. Hard to guess. I think that you could go both almost. Just start off with the run, then maybe a play action, then maybe on like a 3rd and 6 or something, just fool them with the draw and just go up the middle, first down.
Right. Yes, that's awesome. Yeah. So here's the snap, and it's a run play down the middle. Gets taken down hard on that turf. But that was a great gain. Tony Cavaliero Santana. About 6 yards on the play. That's going to put him at 2nd and 4. Got 2nd and 4 here.
As we have a
2nd and 5.
Running back slash fullback here coming in the game, Christian Ryder. So let's see if he can make a big difference.
You don't know if they're going to play them at the running back or fullback position because they have some good running backs, but you don't know where they're going to play them. As you see Pally preparing for the snap. You got 2 running backs in the backfield. That's an interesting formation there. I like the formation. It looks like they hand it off here. It looks like just taken for about a no-yard gain. Pretty good. I think they could have maybe done something a bit more than just running the ball there. Maybe just thrown it or something. Could have been more of a positive factor for them,
and
in my opinion.
I think you could go play action here. Maybe even just go back to that draw that we were tying up, but looks like draw might not be happening
I'm
here.
I'm thinking double play action to these 2. Oh, look at that. Just definitely mistimed.
Yes.
Very mistimed.
Big penalty. Let's
that's what that snap count.
Good snap. Defense, number 51. That's 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Yeah, just big first downs.
Yeah, that's what that snap count can do to you. You know, the QB's there going hut, 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 you know, like that. And, you know, you get very confused up there. That's why you got to keep your mental focus on when they say hike and when the ball moves.
And Pally is used to this crowd, and so it's not affected as much from them, but even the crowd noise can take effect on the defense trying to guess
True.
The snap count.
So they can't hear as well because this crowd is pumped up. And when big plays come, everyone's on their feet, you know, and just cheering loud as they can.
I think, once again, just go run, play action, draw. First down, just like that. That's what I would do.
Yeah, run it, get the play action, draw. That's pretty, you know, common use, and that's exactly what they should do.
But, I mean, let's see. They could have something else.
It looks like they just go for the pass on first down, finding it over the middle.
That is Amel Wolfgram, not able to hold on there. He's actually a senior there, tight end. So let's hope that he can make a big impact in this game.
Right. He just got hit in the shoulder right when he was about to catch it and just spun him around. That's why he couldn't hold on to that ball. It seems like they're making some substitutions. Number 11 and number 5 coming. Justin Hull was actually on the sideline getting some plays from the coach, and they're ready with their play.
And after that drop, I guess Amel Wolfgram is now back on the sideline.
Yep, after that good play. Takes a snap, going back, getting very pressured. It's a screen play, that's why. And ooh, he gets taken down. He just split those. He went between his 2 offensive linemen, and there was just a defensive lineman waiting right there.
We were talking about if Christian Ryder could make a big impact in this game. I mean, even though it was only a short gain there.
3-yard gain?
Yes, it's just still better than an incomplete or something. Just able to hold on, get a couple of yards there.
Very good. Now they have a 3rd and 4 here. In this case, I'd probably give a draw play. They've thrown it twice. Looks like the QB calling for a timeout, and they will get one.
Timeout, Palo Alto.
Second timeout here. Yep, and
with 4:33 left to play, already the second timeout called. That's big.
Yeah, but this is the first half, so There's no need to panic with all these timeouts being called. That's just really, you need to save them when it gets to that second half. That's very important.
Yeah, but I mean, still, if you want to get a touchdown at the end, then you're forced for sideline. You can't just throw deep down the field and get tackled. You have to rush there, and then that's going to take a lot of time off the clock. Maybe you don't even get another play after that.
Yes, and then I think they're going to save that last timeout for one of those situations, or trying to just maybe use it for exactly what they've been using it with the other two.
Maybe you also want to save a timeout for the end so you can try to ice the kicker.
Exactly. Ice the kicker is very important because this kicker is one for two, and, you know, they probably want it to be one for three next.
If they can. I mean, it's high school, and just the pressure of the crowd noise. And even Sequoia can do that to Pally. I mean, same thing, just gets them thinking too much. And when you think too much, that's when bad stuff can happen.
As we have 4 minutes, 30 seconds, Vikings at 14 versus the Sequoia, which are at 13. Because of that one missed, you know, extra point, which we said could be a big factor. Here they are in that same formation. They're changing the formation to put the guy out on the wide. And now he's going deep for the throw again. He's throwing it over the middle. Knocked down by Sequoia.
That pass was intended for Brian Jefferson, tight end / defensive lineman.
Right.
Yeah, so now this is where if I'm Pally, I don't want a big return. So I'm aiming towards the sidelines, maybe around the 15.
Yeah, that would be the, you know, what you would want to do. And, yeah, 4th and 7 here, and it looks like they're punting, actually. Yes. So here they are with the punt. It's a nice high punt. Here goes the return. Oh, look at that. Oh, he's chasing after a Pally.
Ooh, what a punt.
They're going to let it roll, and it's going to be downed at the 5.
Wow. That is, like, more than 5-yard line there. And that's just a great punt. Especially think about high school. I mean, that's amazing. That's, like, pro level there. Let's see. Hopefully he moves. That punter can just move on there.
And if I'm Pally, I'm not letting up the deep pass, but I'm also thinking they're going to run. So I'm playing I'm playing a zone defense blitz. Because if they play a zone defense blitz, they blitz on because, you know, most teams run when they're next to their goal line.
And who knows, safeties. Think about the safety possibilities.
Yes.
I mean, Maximilian Dorward, he's made both of his PATs. What a punt there. It's crazy.
He's a very good kicker
and
slash
he's
punter.
And he can play DB, which, you see, he's playing DB in the slot there.
Yeah, he is. As it looks like they're going to run it, and he's getting a lot of yardage here. Oh, he's still going. Taken down at around the 25. Great run. That was for about 20-yard gain.
Yeah, just that's exactly what Sequoia needed to do. Now there's no pressure of being back by their own goal line. So let's see now.
Taking the quick snap. Oh, he fumbles a little, but he still has it. And they ran the ball down at about the 30, 5-yard gain.
We were saying, I mean, Fefe Brown, I mean, that's just incredible, this game he's been having.
Yeah.
So, let's see if they'll give it back to Fefe Brown.
You're right. And so it looks like we have just waiting for the formation to happen here. Get some substitutions from Pally, substitution from Sequoia. 1st and 10 right now.
Number 52, James Cohey coming out for Pally.
And here's the QB right now. Gets a snap, runs it, down to the side, taken down by number 90. That was like a wrestling move right there. He just grabbed him and took him down.
Yeah,
nice tackle.
As you see there in the picture, Renick Sloan still no catches, and we're getting towards the end of the second quarter.
You would have thought he would have something by now. Let's probably keep a good close eye on him because he might come out of nowhere and just do great.
Yeah, couldn't say better myself.
There's a snap. I'm assuming they were going to throw it, and they are. He throws it deep down. It was so close to being picked off. Went right through the hands of two Pally defenders. they're obviously not that happy about it, but, you know.
That was Maximilian Dorward. Can hang on with the interception. That pass was also intended there for Patrick LaPaparo. So.
Right. So, you know, two Pally defenders. He beat the defense, but it was just a little shortly thrown by the QB. And, you know, could have been an interception. Again, another interception that Pally could not come up with.
Yeah, there's been a lot of those so far.
But here's the throw. He's looking. He throws. Incomplete.
There's a little pushing and shoving after the play by Sean Pike and Sequoia's.
Foul for intentional grounding. Number 36 was in the area.
So as you hear, no foul on intentional grounding there.
Yeah, no intentional grounding because they were in. They were gonna call it that, but there was a wide receiver in the vicinity.
But as I was saying before, just some extra pushing and shoving there by Sean Pike of Pally and Marcus Sattel of Sequoia.
And here, it looked like almost a false start on the offense, but nope, it's a punt off. Here's the receiver. Oh, he fumbles it a little forward, but it's okay. He still has it. Ooh, he got wrapped up and taken down so hard. I'm surprised he I'm surprised he held on to that because he had let go of it. He couldn't hold on to it on the catch and then just gets thrown to the ground. I thought he might have fumbled that, but he was able to hold on, which is good.
Yeah, I mean, just think about if there's a Sequoia player in the area and he comes up with the ball after the drop punt, but luckily for them, Sequoia was not around the area around there, so he was able to pick it up and get like a yard there.
Right, exactly. And the time is 9 o'clock right now, so just so you know. And it looks like they're going to throw it from Pally down the middle, number 81. Ooh. He gets taken down by number 45.
Once again, Eli Givens.
Yeah, the wideout. That is a wideout that I believe is 6'2".
So we're around 2:25 here. So this is where the two-minute drill becomes a factor.
And as you can see, we're going to tell you, Sequoia has two timeouts, but the Vikings, Palo Alto Vikings, only have one because they've used two of theirs to collaborate with their team and get their team focused and set, which has helped them. And here's the pitch play out to the right side, still taking it through, escaping through the tackle, going for extra yards.
That's Paul Jackson. We were talking about just get
yep.
some pit.
The pitch play worked perfectly in everything.
Just that speed is just amazing there. So yeah, he's also big player watching this game, as we say. I mean, returns, running back, big duo here.
Yeah. You'd also have to think here that in the I formation, they're most likely going to use that fullback to block whoever's in front in the run, but they're going to play action, and they're going long. It's deep. Oh, it's a little to the left of where the receiver was. Tough. Eli Givens, again, going to Eli Givens, but...
Yeah, Eli Givens had some separation there
just
from Gavin
little,
Bean, but...
A little left of him just messed it all up.
So we got second down and 10. Maybe you go surprise them with the draw, but, yeah, I mean, it's actually would be a decent idea to try to run down the clock. You don't want Sequoia getting this ball back, of course.
And if I were to guess so far, I think Pally has had most of the possession time. They've had the ball in their hands a lot more, and they've made their chances count. As it looks like he's going for the pass again, escaping out of the pocket, throwing, found by number 15, taken down at the 20-yard line.
What a catch up by Riley Chauvin.
Nice play. It's a great play. Riley Chauvin.
So maybe you go to the draw here. What do you think?
I think they go for the draw. I do think they go for the draw here.
And I think you give it to Calvaro Santana because he is your speed back and he can maybe break through and touchdown or get close.
Yeah, if I was controlling his team, I'd go with the draw. But I don't think their coach is really deciding that. We've seen they haven't really called on the draw a lot in this game. And their game plan might be focused a little away from the draw. They might just run a counter play even maybe here. Looks like they are running the draw, kind of.
That's Sean Pike there.
Sean Pike. Beautiful.
It's just great that he can play running back and fullback. He's a great blocker, as we've seen. and he's able to just break some tackles.
Oh, yes. You need that from players.
Holding. 55 offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay first down.
So they're replaying the first down, which is holding. Just no one ever likes to see a holding call.
Yeah, that's just bad. It's unnecessary from the offensive line. And, I mean, it's hard to stop a person without holding, but, I mean.
You need to learn how to do it.
Yeah, especially here in high school here. As you were saying, high school is the big step forward, and you got to learn how to do it as we have 1:06 left to play.
Yeah, and here we're about to get the snap here. They're in the I formation. I'm not aware of this formation, but they're going to throw it. Escaping from the pocket, he throws. It is looks like that might be complete. Well, let's look what the refs say. They're going to call it a completion.
Once again, Eli Givens.
Big factor, Eli Givens. Gain of 12. We have 45 seconds left and counting, so Pally needs to maybe make use of their timeout in a couple seconds. They can't use too much time on. They need to use the hurry up, but they're going in the huddle here. I would be using that hurry up offense because they still have about 20 yards to gain.
But they still do have their timeout and can just run out the clock and get that touchdown.
25 seconds left as they run it through. And I don't think they're really trying to go for that touchdown. They don't really, it's not getting that important to them. It looks like.
So timeout call by Pally. That's their last questionable play call there. But, I mean, the run's been the big factor. I think you go maybe do a fade route here. To Eli Givens or even Riley Sherwin because they're both big wideouts. And we talked before the game, having big wideouts can be a big factor.
Yeah, like if they get in a, you know, one of their. Yeah, well, Eli Givens is 6'1". They also have two tight ends, John Samos and Bryant Jefferson, that are 6'2 and 6'3.
And so around this time, yeah.
If you can fade to one of those guys, you know, that's a big height advantage on the other defensive backs playing.
Maybe you line up a tight end as a wide out, so then the defense has to make the call. Do you want to be able to speed to be able to cover the tight end there, or do you want to put a linebacker there with the chance that the linebacker who would have to cover as a corner, but looks like they will not be doing that here.
It looks like they're also, again, in that same formation that has worked so well for them in the run, as it looks like they're throwing on the fade, just like we said, picked off! Sequoia taking it back. They're going to try to score here. Always taking, So he sidestepped a guy, but that's tripped up, and that's the first interception of the game. 10 seconds left, probably just a Hail Mary here.
That was Gavin Bean here with that pick, and actually I think they'll just kneel. They're getting the ball first in the second half. This is exactly how they wanted to play it.
Yeah, I mean, if I were coach here, maybe I put in a run play, call the quick timeout maybe, and then maybe throw it deep again or throw it twice. I don't know.
Or maybe you just maybe throw a screen pass because you never know. You can just explode down the field.
A screen pass might be good too.
I think just don't.
That wastes up a lot of time. You got to remember that.
Looks like they are going in kneel formation, and this should end the first half.
They're going to kneel it to end the first half. He fumbles the ball on the kneel, but. So this is the end of the first half. Score 14.
That's the end of the first half.
14. Score is 14 Vikings and 13 for Sequoia. And here's the halftime. We're going to take a highlight of the first half.
See some of the big recaps.
So we're going to show you a highlight of some of the plays of the first while us announcers take a quick break. I didn't say it.
Oh, okay. 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 Oh, okay.
That's the big thing. I don't know if I can hear with the hoodie on. Someone talk to me. And we're back at Pally, where we still have the Vikings versus Sequoia, which has been a great game so far. Scores 14-13. Vikings in the lead of this game. What do you think the keys to the second half are, James?
I think that QB really need to pick it up a little. And Justin Hull had a big first half. Other side for Sequoia, not as big. I think, but both quarterbacks got a really, actually, both QBs did actually a very nice job. I think they even have to get to their, go 110% here. I mean, it's just so big, close game. This is where you need the pass.
Yeah, it's important. Our camera's adjusting, as you can see, Pally getting ready over there. They're about to charge through, and this is going to be, let's just watch this. Look at the cheerleaders holding each other up. That's hard to do.
As Sequoia making their way out on the other side.
I can take over for you at the start of the half. Okay, so as we see, we have the refs in the middle of field start calling for players to come out, it looks like. As we see the Pally cheerleaders here waiting for the Pally team to start charge through that sign right there. That's what it looks like.
Actually, I like the idea. Just get the Pally players pumped up, ready for the second half. It's going to be a great one.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome if they get to charge through this thing right now. Just rip it up. I think that just give a big boost. It would give me a boost. It's exciting.
You wonder where the Pally players are.
Well, I think they're just still in the locker room getting ready, talking about what they need to do this half.
Because Sequoia is already out there, so it's curious to see when they'll be making their way out.
Yeah, it's a little peculiar, I would say, out of the ordinary, but it's not too much. They're probably just have some decisions to make. Oh, and here the Pally players come. I can see them walking down, walking through. They're not gonna, it looks like they're behind the sign, ready to go. as you can see. Let's see what happens. Rip through the side. That'll give you a pump up.
Yeah.
I'll pump you up. So, Pally running to their bench, and I'll probably just run to the goalpost and back. But I think as we were talking, you know, they were going over their game plan at halftime. Their game plan, honestly, just do what they're doing. Put defensive pressure on their ball and, you know, do exactly what they're doing on offense, and they'll come away. If they keep it like the first, it's game.
And for Sequoia, there's something that's been affecting them, and the QBs really just had the rush of stars, and that's the blind side not being covered.
Yes.
And that's where injuries and fumbles happen.
Right, you really don't want your star QB to get injured by a blindside hit or something. Very important that you have a good player there. Pally doing some high knee stretches right now. Always good to stretch after halftime.
And that's why they say the quarterback may be the highest paid player on the team in the pros, but second is left tackles.
Yes, I think you're right. I would also think running backs get paid a pretty good amount. But, yeah, I just think that it's really important that the offensive line holds up. And this Pally team's blitzing almost every play, which is what puts so much pressure. So what they need to do is play those short passes.
Yeah, just keep doing that. And we've had a big performance on Tonga Alatu. He's as an offensive lineman, he's given Justin Hull a lot of time, and on the defense, he's always around the ball.
Right.
Which player do you think has made a big impact in the first half?
I really think the number 18, the wide receiver, has really made a difference. Eli, I mean, he's so good. I mean, there is really no stopping him when he's, you know, Eli Givenna. There's no stopping him when he's, you know, being guarded. You can't guard him. He's virtually unguardable. And that really helps what Pally's trying to do with their offense right here.
Just
where
think
they're running
about
it and then passing it and running it, passing it. It really helps them.
Just think about how it makes a quarterback's life so much easier when you just can have that open guy out there who's has some separation. You can just loft it up.
Yeah, he's one of those guys. He's almost like a – he kind of reminds me of Calvin Johnson Jr. on the Detroit Tigers in the NFL. He can just – you know, his nickname is Megatron. He can do almost anything. He's one of the top wide receivers in the NFL. And that's what I think Eli is trying to become in this high school, maybe his college career.
Yeah. Funny coincidence that his number is also 81.
Exactly. Maybe he chose it on purpose.
You never know.
So it looks like getting ready. Pally will be kicking because Sequoia won the coin toss but chose to defer. And getting ready for kickoff.
So, I mean, this is why Sequoia's decision to defer actually made is actually gone for the better.
And here's the kickoff, about to start happen. Pally's kicker getting ready for the kick, and it's up. It's flying through the air. Great reception there as he takes it through, sidestepping everyone. Taken down at around the 45, it looked like.
Yeah, big return there. And now Sequoia's got good field position. Just got to go 55 yards here for the touchdown.
Right. Exactly.
So
Matthew Lewis making the tackle there. Good play for him.
Yeah, because if it wasn't for that tackle, he might have gone all the way there.
Sequoia could take the lead, potentially, with this play right here. But if Pally scores again, they have the lead by one. Oh, he's getting stuffed, and everyone joins in to tackle the big fella. They take him down. Three yard loss there, Justin.
Yeah.
That's tragic.
I still think that we were saying in the first half, I mean, still, Renick Sloan went the whole first half without a catch. I still think you should at least get a screen pass or a slant pass or something and just get him going.
Get that quick pass going because they're getting pressured with blitzes from linebackers like, you know, also who the running back is, you know, from Pally. And
yeah.
And there's the throw. Quick little play out, like I said, and can't make the catch. Aya Brown not able to make the catch there. Very close.
So, yeah.
A third and 11 here. We got 11 minutes, 14 seconds left in this quarter. And here's the throw. Oh, it's almost intercepted by Pally again. Good, great coverage. A third time that Pally could have had that interception. I think they got it. They have to get one by the end of this game, don't you think?
Yeah, and I mean, it'd be big there, but I mean, if you think about it, now it's fourth down. They're going to have to punt, so Pally's going to be getting the ball anyway.
Yeah, they will.
So, let's see if there was, we can get a good punt here or a good return. You never know. Paul Jackson III had a nice first half.
He is amazing, and let's see what he can do here. I'm assuming they're going to punt it into the end zone. But no, they punt it very short. They're going to call it off. It's going to be probably going to down it around the 40. Nice, good for Pally. Very short punt, about 20 yards only. Only kicked that about 20 yards. I don't know if that was on purpose or if he was rushed or if that was just a missed the ball kind of when he was trying to kick it.
Another quick note, there was some unnecessary pushing and shoving there by Bryce Desprissy on some shoving on Paul Jackson here.
Yeah, you're going to see that a lot during the rest of the game. We already saw some of it the first half. Here is Justin Hole taking the snap. Ready? He runs it to number 3, and he's still taking it through the line, and he's tackled down. A little extra shoving after the play, as you see again. Looks like an injury. Tony Cavalier Santana taking that ball running. He might have injured someone's leg, might have fell on it funny. You know, that's never good. A lot of leg injuries we've seen already this game.
Yeah, it's not good. Once again, looks bad, but hopefully just pray for a safe recovery. Speedy.
Right. You just hope that he can recover and be back in this game as people get hydrated right here. Trainer coming out to give him some water.
Remember, you got to stay hydrated. That's a big part. As you see a couple players on Sequoia taking a knee, hope praying that their player is okay.
Yeah. Seems like they're just checking out. It looks serious because he can't stand up, it looks like. They would have taken him off the sideline by now. But just looks like he's really hurting, and that's never good.
Yeah.
You just be hoping that he can, you know, get back to in this game. It looks like it's a serious injury. I don't think he's coming back in this game.
No. Maybe that's going to get him for a couple of weeks. Hopefully, though, he can get back in there soon. It's just injuries like this that sucks, and it's sad to think that this is a part of the game, but it is.
Yeah. Injuries are a big part of this sport. As you can see, the score is 14-13 still. It will be 2nd and 4 when we return. Still out there with an injury. Three members of the Sequoia team out there checking him out. Yeah, it looks really, really bad. It looks like he might even be unconscious, I don't know, because he's not really moving around. They might have to carry him off the field. They might have to get the stretcher or a cart or something. You see the loyal Pally fans in the screen here. Even they feel bad for the Sequoia, even their a rival player even getting hurt.
Okay, guys, I'm not ready to
so
and
let's hope that he's okay. He still looks like he's making attempt to get off the field here.
Number 44. That's just a terrible injury to, you know.
And that's the number Sequoias. 44, Arvin Vail.
Arvin Vail. He's a good defensive player and offensive player for them. I believe he plays two positions. He's very good. And it's sad to see him come off the field like this. So he's getting carried off the field by his teammates. And looks like a trainer coming to give him a coat.
Well, at least he didn't have to get the stretcher there.
Yeah, that's a good thing. You know, if you have to get the stretcher, that means it's really not the best of injury. As we take the snap here, looks like a run play. Down the left side, no one there. He's taking it. He's going. And it looks like he gets to the 35. Clarence Santana, great play to the 36.
Great job there, finding his holes. Offensive line, once again, great job.
He got the first, and that's really what's important about that. I think that so it looks like there on the play there was a foul, but I am Luca Giuliani and this is Justin Dunbar, and we are your announcers for today's game. I hope you've liked what MC Media has been put together, and it looks like the ball is being advanced to around the 21-yard line. So the score is still 13-14 at the 21. Still third quarter with 10 minutes, 32 seconds to go. Got a lot of game left. Looks like here's the snap. The running back taking the same running back again, running through the middle and the side, and he gets to about the 6 or 7. Calvero Santana, he's running great. I'm switching up by putting in Sean, Sean right here.
Yeah, just get Sean Pike, that big Pike running back there that can just grind through the middle for the touchdown there.
Get him into this game, get that formation they've been playing so well with the QB and then the two in the backfield lined up equally to each other. That's what they got to do here. Works so well. They're replaying the first down, taking it back. A personal foul on the Pally player. I'm confused. Did you see, was there after the play shoving or?
Yeah, just too much contact. And usually contact's fine, but too much and unnecessary, that's not what you need to see.
Yeah. I think it just, you know. But it's part of the game and, you know, that's why we have referees to handle that call. As the snap comes, Justin Hole looking back, getting very pressured, sacked down. There's a flag. They threw a flag out. That's going to be a high tackle.
Yeah.
Unnecessary roughness or high tackle.
And
let's see what the ref has to say. Two penalty flags out there. Let's see what the refs make of this decision. Face mask. It did look like he may have grabbed his face mask there. I think that's a good call. I think the debate there was about unnecessary roughness and or a face mask and how they were going to judge that call and how many yards they were going to give.
Yeah.
So, they're bringing it to the 22 here. First and 10. So it's first and 11 here, as I said. Lining up in a nice formation. I like this formation with everyone kind of out left. It looks like they're probably going to use the draw play to the right side, I'm going to say. Or they're going to throw it. Throwing it out. Oh, it's dropped. Is that an interception? It is. And it's getting taken back. There he goes. Always stopping. And he's, wow, what a play. Just couldn't catch at the tight end and just picked off. That's what happens.
And that's the big momentum. And they are pumped up.
Here's Sequoia taking over here. Justin Hole That was a good throw. Justin Little's been throwing great all day. Just his receivers, you know, sometimes will make a little fumble, and that fumble on the catch just became an interception.
Yeah.
And that's what Sequoia's really done better than. They have two interceptions, and Pally has none, but Pally's had chances but can't come up with the interception.
Yeah.
On exact same plays like that. So let's see the snap here for Sequoia. They're going to throw it. They're going long down the sideline. Almost picked off. Little pressure there from the offense. So close to being picked off. Max Starward, so close. The fourth time they have missed that interception. It's going to be very interesting to see if they can get one of those interceptions.
Yeah, but I mean, at least they're swatting it away there. Not letting them catch it.
Yeah, as long as there's no catch, that's fine. You want to try to get that extra edge with the interception. As here's the play. About to get sacked. Throwing a screen pass. Still going. He's going very far. It looks like there might have been a fump. Oh, it's an extra fight. It looks like. Someone's injured. Pally player looks like. Lying down, number 50. That's never good. You have an injured Viking on the field, number 50, who is, you know.
Tonga Latu.
Yeah, Tonga Latu. He's a very good player for their team, and sad to see him go down.
Quick note, there's 9:26 left in the quarter.
Right. So, looks like everyone taking a knee for this player. Another injury. Sad, Justin.
Yeah. While we have this break, let's give a quick note out to Pachi's Pizza, which began in the summer of 2004 with the expert pizza maker with a passion for fresh deep dish pizza and genuine hospitality. Pachi's Pizza is as delicious as it can get. So go to Pachi's and get your pizza. You'll love it.
Also, I really enjoyed my Pachi's at halftime, which we were able to eat.
Nice deep dish pizza, always awesome.
Give ourselves a little energy. You know, the players playing out there are giving energy, but us announcers really need to stay hydrated too.
Yeah.
Very important. You see these Vikings are massive players.
As Tonga Latu is able to walk off.
Still limping, looks like on his left foot. And he's got his trainer carrying some things that will help him. It's just another injured player. It's just all part of football. So we look for the snap. I'm assuming a run here is what I'm looking for. And they do run it off. He's immediately stuffed by the Pally. This is what Pally does so well. Their run defense is top notch, Justin.
Yeah. I mean, they've just been bringing the pressure all day. And even when people get injured, the next guy just steps up and it's key.
I know. That's what's so good about this Pally. Bench is great. The starters are great. The seniors really boost up their other players. And it's all just perfectly coming together as they throw a little play action up here. They throw it deep down the field, wide open. He makes the catch. It's a touchdown. Simple play, and now they take the lead 19-14. Sequoia, that just changes the whole game right there.
Big oh, he's play. Limping there.
I think he's got tackled there at the end. He didn't realize, but.
And that is LaMania Brown once again. Big touchdown, but now he's hurt. Just pray that he's okay because he is a big player for Sequoia.
Anyway, here's the PAT. And it's up. And they are saying it is good. So now they have, it's 20-14. If I'm Pally, you just got to score and get that PAT. You're up by one again.
Yeah. PAT is a big part of this game.
And as you can see, you get a good look at the field right here. Zoom in on the Pally bench, all of them getting that Gatorade and water to hydrate themselves. They got the cheerleading team pumping them up.
So what do you think Pally should do here? I personally think that they should do a couple runs and then get a screen or a reverse or something big because they need that big play.
Yeah, I would go for the you know what, a really good play I've seen worked. It's a little bit of a risky play, but if you're Pally, you need to, you know, I feel like this play would be really good if you can execute it well. You put a receiver out on the right and you have a slant play going, but when the receiver on the slant catches it, the guy on the right loops around him and it's a laddie play back.
Oh yeah.
So I think if they run something like that, some tricky play, they can really confuse this Sequoia defense. And here's Paul, and he takes it through. He's muscling through everyone. He gets down to about the 32. Great run back by Paul.
As you see the Pally fans chanting, good job, Paul, because that was just a nice return. And it's good to know that your fans appreciate how good you're doing out there.
Yeah. So they have it at the 37-yard line. The time is, we got 8:30 left in this game, and the time right now is 9:48. So now, Pally, we're going late into this game. So we see the run play. They gain a good amount of yards, I'd say 5, maybe 6 yards. Good run there, 7 yards even.
So actually what you want to do, establish this run game, get a couple first downs, and that's when you do the big slant lateral play or something like that.
I think right now they run the play action here. They're in the I formation, it looks like. I think they run this play action. And they're actually just going to hand it off right through the middle. He breaking three. It looks like he's going. He's at the 20, at the 10. Touchdown. Tony Caballero, what a play. Amazing run there. Touchdown. Game tied 20-20. Wow. Paul Jackson III actually ran that in right there. Wow, yeah. With the good return and the run, just, I don't know what to say. He could be the MVP of this game, I think.
Yeah, just, here's a big PAT coming because it can give them the lead.
This is important. Their kicker has nailed every kick so far, and I wouldn't be surprised if he made it here. And it is good. A 63-yard run. Wow, that is remarkable.
As we were talking about that exploding speed, that's how you get it going.
They gained 5 yards on the first play. In two plays, they gained 68 yards of a 61-yard run and then another 7-yard run. Sorry, 63-yard run and another 5-yard run.
So now Sequoia has to think of something as the momentum is completely shifted. I think just stay true to your game here. It's worked so far.
Here comes the kickoff here. If I'm Pally right now, I'm looking to kick it deep here, not let their return men do much. Kick it high. And it's pretty much as high as you can get it, so your return team can get there in time. It's a nice high rolling kick, and the return team is there. He's going to try to tackle him. He's still going, and they tackle him at about the 34. A little extra shoving after the play, it almost looked like. That's all fine, part of the game.
Yeah, there's been a lot of shoving between Sequoia and Pally. I don't know if it's just part of the game or do these two teams just really just not like each other?
I'm going to guess that they're rivals, and since they're rivals, they really want to beat each other, and they want to try to get that, you know, try to make the other team fear them.
Yeah.
And that's really what they're trying to do, intimidate the other team.
The big intimidation factor, big part of anything.
Three receivers lined up to the right here for Sequoia. I wouldn't be surprised if they went deep, and they are going, but he's getting stuffed up. Fumble! The ball came out. I want to see who recovered it. The ball was downed, it looked like. who came up with the ball is the question. Sacked by Mike and Randy, but it looks like Sequoia still has the ball. Yeah, they're going to call it an incomplete pass. So that was apparently the quarterback was in the throwing motion when throwing, so it's an incomplete pass. As he's throwing, he gets almost sacked again, throws it down, maybe intentional grounding. Possibly.
Looks like number 26, though, was in the area, so I don't think they're going to call it.
Michael Brandon with the rush again. He's just running at that QB, breaking through the offensive line. They need to stop him.
If you remember for the first half, he was actually one of the injured players, so it looks like he's made a nice recovery and is really starting to make a big impact on this game.
As you can see, each team three timeouts. Time is 7:15 left in this quarter. And here's the blitz. Or not really, but here's the QB running to the right, throws it, almost picked. It's picked off! Finally, Powell gets the interception they've been looking for. He gets shoulder bumped and taken down, but that was a great interception. Finally, Powell got that interception, Justin.
Yeah, Ty Wilcox, we were talking about how he was stopping, we're just stopping all the receivers that come his way. Now he gets the big pick.
Yeah, I mean, finally, I mean, they took five chances at the trying to get picks, and none of them they could come up with a pick. And finally, it's awesome to see them get this interception, finally.
Yeah.
And with this momentum building now, if they score a touchdown, it could be, like, it's going to be 20, with the PAT being made, 28-20, and that is a big move. Looks like they're going to run it through here. He gets stopped at about the 21.
Another good run by Paul Jackson, the third.
Yes, he's doing good. I wouldn't be surprised if they put in Big Sean here.
Yeah.
Get some power going up in there.
Here we go. Let's see if Justin Hull can lead his team for the Sean big Pike. Touchdown.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised they're not putting in Sean Pike here. They're sticking with Paul Jackson third. And he's running through the middle. He's making it to the 5-4. Oh, it looks like maybe an injury, but no.
That was Christian Leiter.
Christian Leiter, that's, wow. I thought that was Paul Jackson the third, but it was not. And it seems like, I think that was a great run. It ran for about 15 yards. And all around good play, I think.
Yeah, I have to agree.
Christian Ryder, the running back and DB, was here since 2011, and he's a good veteran for this team.
We'll be a senior next year. Have to fill in for some of these seniors that are going to be leaving. Yeah.
So, looks like they're running it again, and they get the touchdown. Tony Cavallaro Santana again. This crowd is erupting. Palo Alto, the band playing, cheerleaders, everyone just so hyped up about this right now. As you can see, the team really pumped up. Sequoia not looking very happy on the other side.
This is the momentum shift that we were talking about. So much momentum is on the Pali side right now.
The PAT being kicked here. It's up, but it is good.
So now, not only does Sequoia have to score a touchdown, then they got to get that two-point conversion.
Right. That is the key point right here is for Pali to play some defense. But also Sequoia, if they score, I don't want to see them, you know, shoot that that PAT again. I want them to go for that two-point conversion.
Yeah, just because try to tie the game here because we're getting later to the game. Now we're in the second half, so.
Yeah, with it just getting the extra 1 point, they're still down by one. And, I mean, yeah, they could rely on a touchdown or something, but I'd rather have that game tied up so if no one scores, you're still able to be tied and go into overtime.
But first they need to score a touchdown, and
yes,
you know, they've gone two straight drives without it, so especially with that last big pick, they're really going to be looking to improve here.
Interesting fact to point out, there have been no field goal attempts or makes or attempts in this game. Obviously, people going for the touchdowns here don't really need these field goals. For high school, that's easy to see why. Nice kick there. Oh, it's fumbled up. Ref's saying something. He's getting taken. Take him down. He's taken down at the 18-yard line. Great takedown. Little fumble in the air there by receiver.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of muffs from Sequoia. That's something that they're going to try to improve here.
They need to improve that in practices, too. They need to work on that.
Yeah.
And maybe even change their return.
Yeah.
You never know.
But
that might be a strategic
choice. You got to stick with this returner for this game. Then you've got to see where you want to go from there.
Right.
Because hopefully he can just, Sequoia's hoping he can just get back to the way he's supposed to be, in his usual way.
Yes. And here's the play, he's throwing it deep. Oh, a nice catch there. Caught it about the 45, taken down at the 50. That was a nice pass to Bradford, and down at the 49-yard line. And that was a nice pass. It was a great catch over the defender, and it was nice.
Yeah. See if Renick Sloan can finally get the catch that he's been looking for.
Yeah, I mean, he hasn't got it the whole game. I would assume, being one of their top linebacker seniors, that he would get something. He's been playing this whole game, nothing. And it looks like they're going to go to him here. They're running to the right. Oh, but he was not open again. Still getting shut down on the side there by number 19 for Pally.
Ty Wilcox.
Just shutting everyone down. Yeah, it looks like
offense number 36, 10-yard penalty, first down.
So they're going to replay this first down because of the holding call. 10-yard penalty on the offense. So they're going to give it. It's probably going to be first. Yeah, it's first down. Take back 10 yards. So probably first and 10. I'd assume because. First and 20 on the play. Trying to get the snap off. See, we got flags coming in here. Probably a false start encroachment or a something.
Prior to the snap, false start. 57 offense, 5-yard penalty. Still.
And that's what we were talking about, just these false starts with the crowd noise.
And Sequoia can't have this now. They're at they're first and 25 here now. You can't, like, get to that position. You got to try to avoid getting all these penalties.
Yeah. Not good.
First and 25 here. And there's a deep throw. Picked off. Another interception. He's taking it down the sideline. Powering through. Easy interception there. There is no way he was not going to catch that.
Yeah. And now Pally's starting to get these interceptions that we were talking about they need to improve on getting.
Turnover's a key. I think this game could take a big turn on a touchdown right here. This game might almost get out of reach.
Yeah, just make it a two-possession game here, and it's going to be really hard for Sequoia to come back.
Yeah. The team on the sidelines, you can see, obviously pumped up. Also, if you're not outside right now, it is very, very cold. Everyone's very cold and shivering. But they got to play through this. That's one of the parts of football, the weather. Here's a snap. He's running it down the middle, taking the hits and getting to the 35 by Paul Jackson the third.
Yeah, Paul Jackson the third has just been so key for this team today.
Yeah. Just short of the 35. They're going to mark him about the 36. Looks like making a quick little substitution.
You were saying you got to play through the cold, and that's part of football. I mean, us broadcasters here, we're all cold, but
We don't really matter. It's all about the playing right here. I don't actually see our man, number 18, Eli. He's not been – I haven't seen him do anything this second half, so I'm going to be interested to see if he can keep it up. Looks like Paul Jackson the third again, powering for about a 15-yard gain.
Yeah, it's crazy. The clock does actually stop when there's a first down. Just quick note to keep in mind.
That is a good.
Because we got four and
very different from the NFL.
Here.
So it looks like it's huddling up here. They're having number 15 go wide out to the right, and they also have their other guys going out wide. As it looks like, here's the pitch play down. Paul Jackson third, shifting, going through, gets taken down hard. That's okay.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes these runs happen. If you want to stay to a run game, you've got to just go power through these no gainers. And because Paul Jackson has the potential, and we've been seeing it, to go all the way.
Yeah, and Eli Givens, you know, number 81, he is in right now, but he's not made an impact in this, in these here, about 12 minutes which we've played. They're throwing deep, down to 15. He catches it in the corner of the end zone. What an incredible play. Wow, what a catch by Riley Shea.
Yeah.
That's that shift, tide shift right there. 20-35, and with the PAT, which they should make, because their kicker's been perfect so far, they should have 36, up by 16 points. It's going to be very tough to come back here. They need two touchdowns and 2 two-point conversions.
Score here is 35-20. And that's 21 unanswered for Pally.
Wow.
Minutes and 12 seconds to play here.
Right. It looks like we're in a little huddle on the sideline before we go to the kick. As you can see, we have 3 minutes and 12 seconds left. The score is 35-20. Both teams with three timeouts. We are in the third quarter here. See what happens here as we get a good view of the field for the kickoff. The kicker gets ready in his position to kick. He's giving the whistle to go, and it's high. Oh, it's a low one, and it's an easy one for them to fumble as they start going. They're taking it way through. Uh-oh. As he keeps going, take it down and around the 55. Great run back there.
Yeah. That's exactly what Sequoia needed from their return team, as now they only have to go around like 49 yards to get the touchdown.
Exactly.
After a couple picks, this is going to be big to see how the quarterback adjusts.
Yeah, I think they should really look at their run game as a factor right here.
Yeah.
You know, and use their bigger running back players, you know, for one example, you know, they're a very big running back player they had, and just keep using him to their advantage, and they should have this game.
Looks like there's a flag on the play. I wonder what the flag was. What do you think it is?
I don't know. There might have been some unnecessary roughness. Could have been encroachment. As always, there have been a lot of encroachments in this game with the snap count.
5-yard face mask on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Face mask, they're calling.
But only a 5-yard, not a 15.
I did not see the face mask there, which is odd. But it looks like that they are going to take this first and five to their opportunity. And here's the play. Here they're running it to the outside left. Here he goes, taking it, thrown out of bounds. Marked down at around the 30, 31.
And that's the, now they're starting to get the
momentum.
Picture. You got to get that running game going, and they're really starting to get it going.
If they throw a play action, I wouldn't be surprised to throw an out route maybe, or some route where they're not so covered deep. But they're going to run it again, get to about the 34.
So
26.
Yeah, we can tell they're really just going with that run game. I mean, after two picks, I might actually be doing the same thing.
Second and seven now. So here's the throw. He's looking. He gets him over the middle, and he's down at about the 20. Nice play. That's almost a first down. Might be an, about a foot out.
So let's see. What's
Ty Wilcox makes a stop there.
Ty Wilcox has been a big part of this game.
Yes, he has.
Third down and one.
So here's the play. Three and one. They fake the run. Smart move. Throws it across the middle on the out route. Cuts back in. That's definitely a first down. Looks like they got about 12 yards. They got to the 12-yard line there. Nice play. I want to remind you that we have 1 minute and 45 seconds left in this third quarter.
So let's see. Are they going to go back to the run, or are they staying with the pass?
I would run that down to the counter play to the right here. And we haven't seen either team really use the counter play. And they're going to run it with their big guy, 36. Shoving it through the middle.
That's Favre Brown there.
Yep, Favre Brown. As we mentioned earlier, massive guy at running back, fast and strong and big. So that's a great play.
Yeah.
So it looks like here's a snap, and he fakes it, and it's easy run in. Favre Brown gets his touchdown.
Yeah, and the quarterback there, he faked it.
Nice look. Fake.
It looked like he still had the ball there, and he just fooled everyone and just left. And it opens a running room for Favre Brown, and he can just ghost him for the touchdown.
Yeah, that's like one of those plays where, you know, it's not quite the draw play, but, you know, the QB, good instinct to pretend like he's going to pass it. And they get the extra, they get the 2 points there on the two-point conversion.
Now it's a seven-point game, so if they can hold Pally and then get a touchdown, they can just kick the field goal.
Right. I would rather go for the touchdown because...
That's what I mean. Get the touchdown, then the PAT.
Right. Then tie game. You never know.
Yeah.
I'm going to go ahead and take a guess with a minute 30 left. I'm going to guess. I don't think anyone else is scoring unless it's maybe a Pally score. But, that's my guess that we're going to have to wait for the fourth quarter to find out.
Yeah, agreed. But let's just see if they can get a good kick, because Paul Jackson, third explosive guy back there, he can just do some great things.
Right. We'll see what happens on this return. I'm expecting that he gets it past the 50 on this one. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I think it's possible, but Sequoia can just bring the heat and get a nice kick. It's going to be hard for him here.
You're right. And here's the kick. He gets the whistle. And it's up. And here he goes. Paul Jackson the third. Let's see what he can do. Going through. Cutting right and left. Gets stopped by one of his own players down at about the 30. I think I might have jinxed his lucky streak of getting past that 50-yard line.
Yeah. So I think just... if I'm Pally, just my goal would be to keep hold of the ball till the end of the third quarter. Just don't let Sequoia get it for the rest of this quarter.
Right, I would try to milk the clock, as they say, and just all run plays. and try to get an even field goal range, or, you know, you can always get the field goal, and that gives you the extra hit.
Well, yeah, but they can just go into the fourth quarter. They don't need to kick the field goal right then.
Yes, and there's an easy run up the middle. Great run to almost the 45.
Yeah, just great job there by Paul
Mark
Jackson.
Down at the 42.
Once again, Paul Jackson.
Paul Jackson the third. It looks like he might be injured there on the field.
Ooh, that's a big
injury. That's not
injury.
Good. That's a big injury for them.
Looks like he's grabbing his knee.
It's all been leg injuries today. That means that at least means that all the players are tackling at a decent level at the legs, which is good. Looks like he's back up, walking to the sideline. Probably going to play Mr. Pike.
Yeah, looks
Sean
like
Sean Pike.
Looks like Sean Pike's in.
And I would assume they run it to him down the middle on these plays. The clock is ticking, and it is at 1:15 and counting right now. You got to try to get this in a field goal range.
Yeah.
I wouldn't expect the touchdown. They are going to throw it here. Looks like a screen pattern outside. Oh, they got a lot of yardage here. They're still going. This could be a touchdown. This could be always taken down right at the 10. They're definitely in field goal range now, Justin.
Yeah. And now they can just go for the touchdown that happens. We'll see.
But we have a minute left. And I'm going for a touchdown here.
Me too.
Obviously, but if you can't get that, go for the field goal.
Yeah, I wouldn't force it. If it was like 4th and 10, I would just try for the field goal because you're around what it would be for a PAT anyway. So, yeah.
Yes.
We got a flag on the play.
Turning around, holding. Offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay first down.
Wow. That is a huge, crucial penalty. Because look now where they are. They're all the way back at around the 45-yard line. Probably placing the ball at about the 50.
So let's see.
Marked at the 49, yep.
See what they'll do here is we'll get.
It's like here comes the snap. Justin Hole taking the snap again. Nice pitch play out. He's taking it out, and that's a nice run there at a 40. I'm sorry for the technical difficulties with the replay. Hi.
So, let's see if they go with the play action here. I mean, once again, Eli Givens hasn't done much here in the second half.
Yeah, I would see with 45 seconds and counting, you got to try to throw it deep and then try to run it once you're in that goal line.
So let's see if what they'll do here.
Here we go. And there he goes. Running to the, it's probably a no yard gain there. And the quarter, it is it. There's 22 seconds left in the quarter.
So yeah, maybe
much,
one
not
more
much time
play.
Left for Valley.
Maybe you get one play here and then we'll go to the fourth quarter.
It is at 10 seconds now. I'm going to assume they're not going to even get a playoff here. It's 5. We're about to go into the fourth quarter. And third quarter is over. 28. The Vikings are at 35. And Sequoia, 28. 7-point lead for the Vikings going into the quarter.
Yeah, a lot of good offense so far.
Right, these refs discussing their game plan for the fourth quarter, as it can get very intense.
So yeah, and so what do you think both teams will do here?
I would assume that Pally plays it conservatively, running the ball, trying to milk this clock. But there are 12 minutes, so I wouldn't be milking the clock yet. I would be doing exactly what they were doing until about 5 minutes when you want to start milking the clock.
Yeah.
But also run a little more than you have been, because you want to milk the clock a little extra more. So it looks like we have the Pally huddle right there. Justin Hole holding it right now as they're coming out right now. It looks like it's going to be okay for them. And again, a shot of us, Justin Dunbar, and myself, Luca Girlani. So we got Pally versus Sequoia resuming fourth quarter. There's a run play. Oh, it's a reverse to the outside. And there he goes. He's going very far. It's a touchdown. That's got to be a touchdown right there.
Eli Givens.
Amazing.
Man.
And we knew Eli Givens had to do something in this.
Two timeouts late in the game.
I would not be calling a timeout right now. I mean, they might need to talk it over with their defense, but, you know, I think they need to save their timeouts because with 8 minutes left in this game, they're down, really trailing bad here by 14, two-possession game. They're going to need those timeouts later, and I think they're going to really regret it. They're going to run out of timeouts.
So let's see what comes out of this. But who knows, maybe Sequoia will come refreshed here and maybe get a big interception or fumble.
Yes, that's always something that could happen too. So, looks like we're going to resume play here in a bit. Looks like Sequoia is ready to come on the field. Here we go. It's, as you look at to the far right of your, to the far right, Eli Givens is out one-on-one. I wouldn't be surprised if they fade to him. Oh, nope, safety moving over there to cover him. Now they got two people on Eli Givens. He breaks his defender, but there's a run. And it's a nice run to about the five. Christian
yeah.
Ryder.
Another just.
On the sweep play
nice
right there.
Nice run there. I like the call for the sweep there.
Very good play. I'm going to guess they have about second and goal, right? At the 7 yard. Second and three. And it looks the ball is on the 7 yard line. So we got. I wouldn't be surprised if Pally doesn't even use any of their timeouts anymore because they don't want to stop that clock. They're going to keep it running. Looks like he gets out around the outside. Almost puts that ball over for the touchdown, but that was Eli Givens on the reverse there. What do you think about what they got to do here?
I just love the call for the reverse there, and I think now I think he just punched it in with Sean Pike.
Right.
Third down and one.
We haven't seen him really this – we haven't really seen him this second half, so it would be interesting to see.
Or you just run to Justin Hole quickly Sean for Pike. a first down, but I'm not sure if you want to do that.
I would not want to really risk Justin Hole's health to
on
a QB sneak from this far away, too.
Maybe so just give it to Eli Givens.
The ball is on the 6 yard line. They gain 1 yard last play. They're going to power right through the middle. Looks like they are saying no touchdown, not yet.
But they do get the first down.
Very close first down. First and goal.
So let's see. I think maybe you can go fade or you can go run. I think you try to run, get some nice yardage on this play, even if it's not a touchdown, just set up your nice second down play.
And that clock gets milked too. Yeah, after you run it here, I wouldn't be going right to the play next. I would wait for that clock to keep winding down until you absolutely have to snap.
Maybe I'd go when play clock's like really down, like at five.
Yeah.
Just you don't want to.
So Palo Alto also using a timeout here to find out their goal line plan.
I'm not sure about that. I would have just kept the clock milking, just run up the middle. But
well, that clock wasn't going right then. It was actually paused for the first down, remember?
Oh, yeah, but it ends up going after a while. It doesn't stay paused the whole time.
Right.
So maybe a play action. What if you do a play action rollout, and either you can hit your tight end on a corner, look for wide out on a fade, or you can just have the QB, if there's no one around, just go run for the touchdown.
Right. Still a 14-point lead for Pally here. And if they score this touchdown, 21-point lead, this game is out of reach, in my opinion.
Yes, I actually agree. I mean, I know there's still 7 minutes to go, and it's a miracle, but a touchdown here could be showing that Pally's getting close to the dagger.
Right. As we see Pally getting ready to take the snap, Justin Hull taking it from not the standard position, not shotgun. He's going to take it, run it. Looks like they're going to award a touchdown. 20-point lead. Sean Pike running it in there. I think this game might be over. It's at 48 right now with the PAT 49.
Yeah, I mean, good call there going to the big guy, Sean Pike, and might be the dagger.
Let's see. We have 7 minutes left in the game. The time right now in Palo Alto is 10:38. And it's fourth quarter right now. Got to, you know, everything just going
see
well for Pally.
Pally can just hang on here, then have a nice little party after the game and have some pot cheese pizza.
Yes. It looks like
a touchdown drive, 60 yards, 7 plays.
That was a good milking of the clock, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I mean, they milked like 6 minutes off there.
Speaking of milk, always head down to Pachi's Pizza because it is made of completely fresh ingredients. Pachi's began in 2004 in Palo Alto with one expert pizza maker, and now it's a great, delicious pizza. And whenever you go there, it's just really good, and you should really go ahead and try Pachi's Pizza.
Yep, love it. Most delicious pizza around.
It's very good. So Sean Pike does have an injury, but on the bright side, Pally, they're gonna, you know, they're gonna make this PAT, assuming most likely they are, and they're probably gonna go on to win this game. Looks like the PAT is no good. So 20-point lead here. We're gonna have a kick here. 7:05 left in this game.
If Sequoia wants to make any effort to come back in this game, they gotta do it now with some urgency.
Right
no
now.
Run. No runs. You gotta go down the field.
Yep. It's throwing that ball, getting out of bounds. Throwing that ball, getting out of bounds. That's all what it's about.
Yeah.
And hurry up the offense if it's, you know, not out of bounds.
Yeah, even with 7 minutes to go, you're down by 20.
Exactly.
This is the mistake limit for Sequoia is 0. Basically, a turnover could be the dagger for Pally.
Right. So here's Pally. I wouldn't be surprised if their kicker might buffle this ball again. He's buffled it twice. If this ball is in front of him and not caught by him. Watch, there it is. He's fumbling with it a little once again, but he's running through. Making a good move to the outside. He's at the 30. He's going down the sideline. Oh, he's taken down, given a nice big man hug down at about the 44-yard line.
Yeah, that's a big return. That's what they need. Now they got to go deep here, and maybe they can get this touchdown 2 to 3 plays if they just go deep. Let's see. Maybe actually on the first play, maybe run a draw. I mean,
maybe.
Hurry up and then do a play action just like that. And go deep, but.
Yeah, they would not expect the draw play, and you have 7 minutes to use here, so.
Or just go to your play action deep, or just run a flood down the middle, or some seams.
Yeah, I'd be looking at a flood or slant pattern,
or maybe
an out route so you can get out of bounds.
Or go four verticals.
Looks like they're going to run the ball here on the draw play. And stuffed. Fave Brown.
Yeah, and. Interesting call, and that's what I said they probably would draw here. But now they got to go. They got to go. Quick.
They got to go. Hurry it up. The clock is ticking. And they are going in the hurry up offense. So here is the snap.
Actually, there's too much time being wasted here.
wasting a little too much time. They got to snap this ball. Come on. This is a snap. Fake the play. They ran it to the left. Caught. Taken down at about the 49-yard line.
But it's in the middle, so the clock keeps going.
Exactly.
Around 6 minutes left in this one.
And they're going to hurry up again, obviously. They have two timeouts. We need to remember that. They have two timeouts. So here's the fake pass again. Same thing to the left. Knocked down by the defensive line. It was a nice block there by the defensive line, just getting their hands up.
I have nothing wrong with the play selection. I just think that the QB could have looked somewhere else. That guy was double covered and tried the force, and I get the rush of panic in your, when this happens, and they're only in high school. So, but still, I mean, you've got to be
gotta look at your other options.
I mean, you look for your number one option there, but then if not, you got to look
number
somewhere
two,
else.
Three. So here's the hurry up again. He's going, he's looking, and he's going to draw. He fumbles it, but he just dives on it. That's, you can't make that mistake.
Now the clock keeps going down. We got,
and now the offense is coming on the field. That was a turnover. That was fourth down right there, trying to run the draw play, and they fumbled it. This might be the end of the game because of that play right there.
Yeah.
Very, very key.
They couldn't score, and now Pally can just try to milk some of this clock off.
Yeah, I totally agree with you.
It was 5:48 to play. This is around the time where you seriously got to milk some clock. No passing.
All you got to do is just run it and then wait until that meter when you have to hike it goes down. Then just keep doing that until your time runs out.
And coming into the game now, number 44, Christian Ryder. He's had a couple of nice big plays here, but basically all you're looking for is just a couple of nice runs here. Get a first down, just milk some of this clock.
And here they go, milking that clock. Nice gain, taken back a little bit, but Tony Gaviero Santana taking it. He's been one of their key runners, too. A lot of running backs have been very key in this game.
Just needing five more here for a first down, which would be huge.
Very crucial to get that first down.
As Riley, the clock's Schoenburn still coming back into the game.
The clock's still ticking to the left. It's at 5:15 and counting. Second and five here. I wouldn't be surprised if they take a little more time to hike it. And there's the snap. Feeds it off. Nice little run for first down, most likely.
So let's
still that clock going. We're at 5 minutes now. The clock has been stopped due to the first down.
That's the only bad thing about a first down. Of course, first down, more time to look, but it'd also be kind of cool if, like, you could get, like, the offense could select for the clock to not stop.
Yeah, that would be something that might help them.
But the clock is now running once again.
Yeah, the clock's now running now that the team's here. And it looks like they're going to run it again in the I formation. This is the give off to the, oh, he runs straight through the middle. This could be another touchdown. He's at the 10. Oh, he gets taken down at around the 5-yard line. Well, a little extra fighting after the play. Touchdown. It is a touchdown. He rolled into the end zone off the other player. It looked like he was taken out at the 5, but he just kept going.
And there's your dagger.
There's the dagger. It's this. Sorry to break it to, but this game is pretty much out of reach.
But if you're Sequoia, you've got a whole season ahead of you, so you still got to get ready for next week.
As we see a good shot of the cheerleaders still out here performing for their fans.
Lots of cheer about here as they're winning by a lot, and this is exactly how you want Pally to play.
The score now is 28-54. I repeat, 28-54. And they're going.
Wow.
So as you can see, some of the things on the sideline including a massage chair, are being packed up for the Pally team. So they're packing up some of their things.
Yeah.
Pretty much they know that this game is pretty much wrapped up.
And that's when the little things can happen where even if Sequoia doesn't win, they'll just chip. They can just chip away.
Yeah, if they chip the lead, that won't be as embarrassing as losing this much.
Yeah.
Here's Pally on the kickoff, and here we go. And they're making a quick little substitution to the kicking team, it looks like, but now they're good to go. They kick the ball very deep, caught by the returnman. He's going to return it. He's good when he catches it, and he runs straight through, but he gets tackled right at around the 25 to 28-yard line.
So, I mean, just don't worry about this. Like, don't force it. Just go nice, easy, smooth drive. Get ready for next week because next week is key. Just get everyone, like, in form because, you know, opening week can sometimes be hard, but, you know, just get everyone ready for middle season form.
Exactly. But here's Sequoia on the play. They give him the run, and he powers it to the 35.
Another thing is Sequoia actually might be milking the clock now, too.
Yeah, I think Sequoia wants this game to be over a little bit. They kind of know it's out of reach.
You see 4 minutes left
on this clock.
Once again, Tonga Latu.
As there they go, running it again. Definitely getting rid of this clock. They know they lost, and they just want to get out of here. So it looks like 3 minutes, 45 seconds to go here. The score is 28-54. Pretty much game over here.
Yeah. I mean, it's good that they're getting their running backs work, though.
Yep, and they're letting the running back take it again. He powers through. Oh, a little extra shoving after the play. If you see down there in the bottom, at the middle of your screen, number 90 and number 5 were shoving each other at the very end of that play. And they're guarding each other, so if they throw here, that'd be interesting to see if there'd be some pass interference down there.
Yeah.
But they're probably not going to throw, and they're going to run it. But if you keep your eye on them, right in the very bottom left, right corner, as they run again, swallowed up. Yeah. 3 minutes left to go in this game. And both teams are counting down the seconds until game is over. Third and 5 here. And getting the call from the coach on the sideline. The QB's taking it. He gets a snap. Obviously hands it off again. Running back powering through. I don't think that was enough for a first down. And I believe it'll be fourth down now.
Looks like maybe fourth and 3, fourth and 4. Looks like they're actually going to bring the punt team here.
I was thinking they were just going to power through for the first down and keep running it.
I think they're just going to be fine with Pally just milking out the clock to end this game.
Yeah. To get a good shot of the field. Two returners back, ready for action. And here we're getting ready for the punt. Here's the long snap and the kick. Very line drive-ish kick. Picked up by the returner. And he's still going. He's going. He's still going, breaking off the tackle. And he's down at the 50. Charlie Stevenson, a guy we have not seen tonight, running a great run.
Yeah. good to get some, especially when you're up by the sleeve, to get some guys that haven't gotten that many reps in today. Just get them some work.
We got a minute 15 left in this game. And
I would actually let the backups come in and just finish this one off, but they might just go with their starters.
Get your backups in there, get them some reps in the game time. Let their parents here in the crowd see them play.
After the play, personal foul. Late hit. Number 3 of the return team. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
See, there's a late hit there from the return team. Now, that's something that they do, the refs do. They'll call. If I was a ref, I don't think I would be calling that because, you know, that's kind of just like slowing down the game. And, you know, the game's pretty much already over.
Well,
so
it's still the ref's job.
It's still the job, though, yeah.
To get the calls right.
It's pretty much I'd be a bad ref.
Yeah. Actually, it looks like their backups are in.
Yeah, playing all their backups, even their backup.
It's the quarterback, Jordan Schilling.
Jordan Schilling is also a they're going to run it down through there, and he's still going to 40. Oh, let's mark him about the 40-yard line.
That's a nice run.
We're at
there.
1 minute and counting.
Finally, we get to see Jesus Ochoa for the first time today.
Right, which we thought he would have been in earlier, but it seems he is.
Yeah, 50 seconds left and counting.
Pally huddling it up. Maybe try to run to the outside, maybe add on some more insurance. So there's the snap, gonna run that again. Take down. 30 seconds left in the game.
And that might do it.
It's pretty much gonna do it. They're giving the.
Oh, but.
On the sides of the field, they're taking off the fences. They mark the field and. That's and you know how you know the game is over. So we're gonna go for one last play here. Here's a little run and he's running through stiff arm, taken down, 45, and 2-1.
That is a game.
That is game. Well,
that's the end of the game.
There's the end of the game. Pally rejoicing here, the varsity team winning this game. That was a good game. The final score, Sequoia 28, Pally 54. This has been MC Sports, Luca and Justin, and this game was just a great all-around game from Pally, scoring lots of runs, and they did very, very good. So this has been Luca Giuliani and James Dunbar, and this is us. We're going out.
Justin Dunbar.